And then
we just
way to start the episode.
We
just
turn
my finger in my eye.
You know what? Let me. Can somebody from Discord speak?
Hello.
Okay. Awesome. There was no sound whatsoever. I was like, God damn. Okay, no, it's all.
Working. No.
It's all working. It's all good. We do have a fan on. Should we turn that off? Maybe. Like I said earlier. Yeah, so I'm gonna go turn the fan off.
Okay.
I can't hear.
Don't melt.
It's fine. If it gets too hot, we'll put it back on. It's just because this goes on YouTube, whereas the other streams don't, so it doesn't really matter as much.
I mean, YouTube or not, you still gotta be able to make it through it.
No, I'm gonna melt. I will become a pool.
Melt.
All right, well, just don't overheat.
We have iced water. It's all good. Anyway.
Water.
Does somebody want to give us a recap?
I think it should be Briar. I think so.
After everything I did? What do you mean?
At least your part should be. Your heist gone awry. Or exactly the plan, depending on who you ask.
I'll read the recap.
Okay.
Husker and the dwarven member of the Onir's men took to outside, preparing to fight one another. The tension was quickly dispersed, but not before Husker received a swift punch to the face. As the group emerged, Husker spoke to the half-orc member of the Onir's men, named Al, and was given the holy book. Gregor approached, and after some discussion, it seemed that Gregor's father seemed to be kind of moon by the orc man. And Gregor also asked about the Sunder, and it was revealed that he hadn't done it yet. But we found out that he's supposed to go to a location between Citadel and Elysia to prove his strength to some great spirit of some kind. And then we headed off to rest, and we came across a game of Royal Gambit with a group of men in leather armor and orange cloaks at like 2 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
And we decided to join in, and I bet 2 favors to the men, and I lost both times, so I don't owe them work, I guess, technically.
Forgot about that.
But we did learn quite a bit more about the underbelly of Citadel. We learned about like the power dynamics and the colors of the clothing of the guys that we do know about. You also found out that I had a ring that had the royal signet on it, and then I just moved on.
No big deal.
No big.
Then we went to go and meet with the weasel, and on our way there, Thal went to the temple and he found the note and flowers that were given by the Onir's men, and it said, "Traz is out, we're staying in Castle's Rest, come see us if you want to." And then we swiftly moved on to the Walk Tavern, which led us to the weasel through like a little back door entrance. Another half-orc man who used to go by the Jackal, but when the new wolf took leadership, they changed his name. And he was friends with the last wolf, so the name change indicates some sort of hostility going on there.
Damn hostile.
He wants the wolf, the new wolf, taken down, and he also wants information on the other criminal groups. And I think subconsciously kind of wants us to tell him what happened to the last wolf, right? He said he just kind of died. I don't know if that's
a
thing. Then we went to the library in the Owl's District, and I went there disguised, and we made a plan that there was going to be a book thief. So I went to go steal an important book to try and get the Owl's attention, and I got distracted by saving a tiefling girl, who then was like a book restorer, and she gave me her card. It was all very romantic.
Sure.
And then Albert, the librarian, came and stopped me from stealing the important book.
Surprising.
Shocking. And now I'm locked inside the library with several guards outside, and I'm alone with Albert, but the party is outside, and they saw that all the customers were being ushered out by the guards. And that's where we ended last session.
Will you say wolf for me one more time?
Wolf.
I love how you say that. Wolf.
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 Okay, yeah.
It's delightful.
We'll pick up outside, because we...
Okay.
Did quite a bit with you yesterday in the towards the end. And we'll pick up outside where, as you guys are all stood there, you see the guards in the blue uniforms pull out these, like a good handful of people, maybe like 10 or 20 people, all like exit the building.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, we're all sort of like crowding around outside, just generally waiting around. There's like a few conversations. Most of the guards go back inside, but there's two guards left outside that then close the door, and that's where we ended last session. So that's what you see. There's like a few small arguments going on between like some of the people who were in the library who were forced outwards, and the two guards that are outside who are just like generally saying like, it's fine, we'll work it out soon. There's just a small bit of maintenance going on.
Oh dear.
Maintenance.
Oh no. Excuse me, what are the chances we can get into the library right now?
Not. There is no chance.
No.
Zero chance?
Zero. There is currently, see, the books, the very old books, they need to be properly maintained at a certain temperature, and right now, the way we cool the building is all out of whack, so the extra bodies inside of there is causing irreparable damage to the books. So
I see.
Unfortunately, until that is sorted, you may not enter.
Sounds like bullshit. But okay. Sure.
We may be back. I want to usher everybody together. Did anyone see a back door or a window on the side, perhaps?
There has to be more than one entrance into the library. But I'd wager a bet there's guards guarding those as well.
Well, I think we should take a look. I want to look around if there is space around the library to like walk around it. I want to kind of see if there's...
The roads around the library are pretty open. It's sort of like within its own like little garden. There's a few buildings in front of the stairs that lead up to it with a small fountain, like a big mosaic like tiled area around it. Around to either side, there's just pretty open paths that flank this very large glass building, as it was described last time. And really, that's about it. As you start walking down the side roads.
Yeah.
Okay, you start walking down the side roads, and around most of the corners, there seems to be small entrances, like small doorways, that do have one guard just stood there protecting it in the same armor. If you keep going around, you see a small door, like leaning against the floor, that maybe like would open into a cellar. There doesn't seem to be a guard there, but it does seem to be like have a pretty hefty padlock on the outside. And then, as you make your way around the rest of the building, again you see a few more small doorways that maybe were there, in preparation for an emergency, that all have a guard on the door.
Hmm.
How heavy is Thal?
How heavy are you, Thal?
Let me cut to the chase. Can I lift him?
With Husker's strength?
Most likely not.
I wager so, but
Husker, what's your strength?
It's not good, homie.
No. Dave, can you check how much you weigh?
Yes, I can.
I got a plus one.
Let's see.
A plus one, 12. So like 14? 12?
12.
What do you say, Dave?
About 450 pounds worth like carry weight.
No. I gotta get it.
You're about 220 pounds off.
Yeah, I try to lift him, and then
you like walk over and sort of grab just, him,
and then I fly onto the roof to look for an ingress.
Oh, okay. I want to go back to the lock.
How naked is the day he is born? Like, what's his base weight without any items on him?
I'm not gonna strip him.
I just want to know in general.
Not worth like, anything to me if he's naked.
Naturally.
Take your chainmail off, I want to lift you.
Yeah, exactly. Well, just let me take 15 minutes to doff this.
Without any armor on or any carry equipment, though, he's like 318 pounds.
Oh my God. What a man!
What a thick unit you are.
Husker, so you're still like in the sort of like central area, and you just take off upwards.
Yeah, straight up. Yeah.
Okay. How about that mind? As you fly upwards, You hear a few shouts from the guards below you being like, no, don't.
Wait. Come get me, pussies.
And one of them pulls out a crossbow and starts aiming at the bullets. But doesn't shoot quite yet. As you get high enough up, you look over the top of this like sort of like large glass building, and there's a lot of windows, most of which look closed, and most of which specifically don't look like they have openings at all. Like they're just like, you know, glass panes put in. There does seem to be a few windows that you think you could maybe open, but they do seem closed, and you don't know what sort of locking mechanism they do have. But you can imagine it's probably pretty, like, they're not really frequented because as we said, from the inside, there's like a large, tall gap from the floor to the ceiling, so they're not very often opened.
I mean, it is glass. Could just kind of create my own opening.
It is. You do hear very faintly, "This is your last warning. Come down."
Am I still in range of them? Can I get, like, over the...
You just want to keep going upwards?
Yeah, I'm just going to keep going. I'm just going to try to outrun the crossbow.
Then after a certain amount of time, they will... I'll say they can get one shot off with disadvantage on you, just on the, like, outward edge of the crossbow range. But I don't imagine it's going to hit, to be honest.
Can I see this as distraction if any of the guards in front of any of the doors that's not the front... like, move away to go see what's happening with Husker?
That seems fair.
Yeah, or this... Maybe... One sec. So, 10 to hit?
No.
That's not a disadvantage, but he shoots upwards, and the arrow just shooms past you, because you just pretty much pass outside of its range. It looks like it's shooting straight for you, and then just falls down and loses momentum.
Idiot.
Sure, you know what? Gregor, one guard, luckily the one that you're near the door of, sort of like stands up and starts walking over to the front to see what's going on. Do you want to try to sneak in through that door?
Yes.
I want you to roll me a stealth with advantage, both of you, if you're both going. You do have advantage because of the distraction, but then you have disadvantage from chainmail, I believe, if either of you have that, so.
I'm sure I have chainmail. I mean, I have chainmail on my face, so...
You'd hope.
Just part of it. Just avoid shaking your head around.
Stand very still.
Wait, do I have... I don't think you do. I have leather armor.
Yeah,
I weirdly think you don't. This came up during the bath discussion.
I'm pretty sure Gregor just wears a chainmail coin, but none of the rest of the armor.
Right. Okay.
Aesthetic.
It's a visual thing.
Okay, stealth is...
So, Gregor would be with advantage, Thal would be straight roll.
I got a 22.
22?
Pretty good.
Come on, Thal.
Come on, Thal. Don't
sneak inside.
Or you could... They're busy shooting a crossbow at me. Why don't you just punch one of them in the fucking head?
Yeah, religious boy. Do it.
Yeah, religious boy. Punch one of them in the fucking head.
Lawful king.
Waffle King, punch!
Y'all go to jail in this town that I love. I've lived in for a while.
This town that I love.
My religious is gonna sneak.
Ooh.
Fine.
If everyone else is going off, I might as well follow.
Okay. What'd you roll?
Y'all are... 8.
Okay.
Y'all are
I knew this was gonna happen.
Gregor, as you sneak up to the door, silence, and you try to open it and you realize it's locked.
Okay.
But not like locked from a key, there's no key lock, but you look on the other side of the door and there's like a little sliding bar.
Yeah.
And as that happens, you hear behind you, as he's sneaking forward, Thal just trips over and just into a heap, all his chainmail rattling.
Okay.
The guy sort of like turns around and doesn't quite see you yet because there's like a little stairway going up to the door that you're sort of hit behind. But definitely sees Thal. Thal, you look up, and there's a sort of like humanoid guard. Not particularly human, you don't think, but a humanoid guard at least looking down on you. About, like, slowly reaching for his, like, this shot slot he's got at his side.
Good afternoon, sir.
Right, and what are you doing here?
No crime
can
here.
I hide?
Yeah, you can stay hidden. You're currently okay. Still hidden.
Okay, cool.
And what are you doing back here?
It's like Bride's son, there's shade over there, right?
Sure.
I want to get a bit of reprieve from the sun.
Right.
Place. Look, you know how it is, right? And I gesture to all of the armor.
And now you've had it, you'll be heading back around front, right?
I will.
Yeah, go on.
Excuse me, and I'll get up. Chains making too much noise in the process.
Okay, if he's making too much noise, can I try to bang the door? Or I want to like knock the thing off of the latch if I can't reach and like move it.
Okay, yeah, I see what you're trying to say. Like you're trying to like jimmy it, like, yeah. You're trying to push it up and then like jimmy it so it can fly the pull up and then lock it in place kind of thing.
Yeah, I'm like getting my axe and I want to like try to time it kind of like Indiana Jones, you know, when they're like stamping the thing and then they're...
Roll me a sleight of hand check.
Sick reference.
Okay, sleight of hand check. I will do that. Let's go. Okay, normal. Nat 20.
Oh my god, okay. That's good. That's pretty much the only way I was going to succeed when there's a guard currently looking at the action. Thal, as you stand up, you sort of shake off a little bit and, like, you know, shake your armor, like you're trying to, like, correct yourself. And as you start walking towards the front, the guard starts walking slightly towards you, so back towards the door, and shoulder checks you.
Unnecessary, really.
Does damn.
Come on.
13 hit?
No.
Okay, I didn't think so. He like shoulder checks you, but kind of gets knocked back off his balance a little bit. And then as you got more past him and that happens, he like turns around to push you forwards into like the open. For a natural one. He goes to push you and just don't move. And then he just seems to get frustrated and just like follows you out, but like not looking at like looking down in a different direction.
No, after that Fal's intimidating, right?
Fal's intimidating. Fal can do whatever he wants as well. Fal can just like turn around and fucking clog this guy in the face. I don't care.
Use punch.
What happens as he walks by you? He tries to like knock you with his shoulder, and just you totally like it's like knocking a brick wall. He just gets thrown back a little bit, and then as you walk past him, he like trying to regain some of his manhood tries to push you a little bit into the open. At which point you just feel this nice firm plant on your back, but no force get exerted past that.
I'll just stop that and look back at him.
It's fucking embarrassing.
Damn.
Just you can try that again if you'd like.
Oh.
I'm going, but I'll play along.
Fuck! he goes, no, I won't. And then as you turn back around, he tries to push you again for a 5 and just.
Yeah.
Force.
I'll pretend that it has a little bit in it.
Roll me a performance. We're gonna see how well you pretend.
Oh, the pain!
Ouchie!
Ouchies!
That's real funny.
Oh my god, yeah.
Why is my life used
up
this?
Well, you force yourself to, like, you as you step forward, you actually force yourself to trip a little bit, so rather than having to act, you do trip a little bit on, like, the ground, and then you, like, stumble forwards, and you look back, and then continue walking forward. A very impressive display.
Alright, well, I'm glad I saved my guy's manhood.
And he continues to follow you. Gregor, on the other hand, while you're there, you... Mm-hmm. There's like being medieval doors, they're not particularly like flush, so you might actually get your hand axe in between the little gap in the door. And as that commotion's going on, the constant like failure to push Thal, you knock it up and then quickly open the door before it can fall back down into the gap again, and the door seems to be open now.
Okay, I will go inside and if I don't see anybody immediately, I want to close the door. Can I close it enough to where it looks closed and locked, but I do not actually put the latch over it?
So the way it would work is it would either have to be slightly open with the latch in front of it, or it would have to be fully closed,
okay.
Or the latch would have to be up, just the way that these doors work.
Right. Then I'll try to close it quietly then and re-engage the lock.
Yeah, yep. As you enter, you see the same room that I described last time, this large open space filled with books, and this this small column in the middle of just of books that are slowly circling their way up and then dropping back down to the bottom where they slowly make circle way back up again. The building looks empty as far as you can tell, apart from you do hear a small conversation going on between a French woman, accent not for the world because France doesn't exist, but a woman with a French accent and a older sounding man on the second story.
Very good.
And then you slowly turn around, close the door, and then re-engage the lock.
Okay. I want to look and kind of reconnoiter the situation. I want to try to get upstairs.
What's that word?
Reconnoiter?
The fuck is that?
It's like to, like, look to examine a situation, I guess, kind of like more battlefield, I guess.
Sure, yeah, let's do it. Reference. We love that word, reconnoiter.
Wow.
Yeah.
Me neither, but I'll take it. Awesome.
Hell yeah. I was gonna rip you to shreds for making up a stupid word, but that's... Wow, egg on my face.
Okay, so yeah, so you look around the situation, you see, like I said, it's a very empty room, apart from there's many books, many tables with books piled upon them, but in terms of people, it's a very empty room. And you head towards the most obvious source of getting upstairs, which is this slowly rotating book elevator. And as soon as you step on one, it slowly does start lifting you up. You can walk up it to make it quicker, or you can just stay on it. Are you trying to sneak right now?
Once I notice that the books do that, I want to try to, like, step down to the one that's coming up to kind of stay at the same level as I look to see the...
So you're constantly just sneaking backwards whilst it's going upwards.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sneaking backwards until I decide to go up.
He's walking down the up escalator. Just what he's doing.
Is a staple in every campaign at this point.
Joe always walks backwards.
He loves it.
19.
Okay, yeah, so very, 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 like, subtly, you just take one step down and you, like, heel toe as you walk backwards to make sure there's no noise. And you slowly start, every now and then you crest over and you see, how did you describe yourself last time? Do you remember?
Ginger, a little bit run down, very sort of like your classic ruffian from the streets. Like, her hair's a bit matted, a bit of dirt on her.
You see that character sat at, like, this small table across from a man that you can only see the back of his head, but you see, like, a very balding, older, like, skinnier man, like, sat at the table having a conversation. We will come back to you now, because now Joe can hear this, but I'm going to assume just for the little while you must keep doing that backwards pedal to catch up on what's going on. Or do you want to full send it?
He sprints.
No, I'll wait a little bit, but I have an idea, but I just want to see what the situation is, if I need to immediately intervene, or if I need to hang back a little bit.
Can I see Gregor as a side note from where he is?
Roll me perception, because he rolled a self, so.
Because I'm the one facing his direction. Yes. 19.
Yeah, you can. You just see Gregor's head peek up every now and then.
Can I see that as well? Looking.
I would say we'll go to Husker. Husker, so you're flying. You're just, like, on the roof, looking down now.
Yeah, I'm just, like, going over the glass panes.
Sure, roll me a perception as well to see if you can just spot Gregor just from the way you are.
Can I see Husker fly over the roof?
I'm looking for either of them.
So.
He's a bright yellow
bird. Roll me perception. It's a lot more likely.
We're all perceiving out here.
17.
Yeah.
I got an 8. That sucks.
You can see, you can eventually see, it takes you a little while, but you eventually see this ginger woman. But you don't see Gregor. Like, he's sort of, like, just always in the wrong place for you to be able to notice him. But you also see Husker.
Just witness these two men emerge and I'm like, oh no.
So to quickly go back to you, across the table, I'm just a little bit concerned about you, that is all. You should really not be getting involved with anyone of the menagerie.
The menagerie? Is it a fancy name?
Yes.
such an establishment, why should I not be getting involved with them?
But they are, they're ruffians, they're criminals. It's just not a good business to really get involved with.
But you're involved with them.
Out of necessity, not out of
what
willing.
What if I told you mine was also out of necessity?
Then, do as you... I am not telling you what to do, I'm giving you advice, dear. You can choose to take it or leave it as you will.
So just to clarify, you don't have a way of getting in contact with the owl.
Picks up that piece of paper again and lifts it up in front of you.
Just double checking.
I am very sure, yes. Unfortunately, I cannot help you. I wish I could.
Well, you could. What if you let me take your fanciest book? And you pretend that you did not let me take it, and then they have to come and get it.
No.
Okay, well, it was worth a shot, I suppose.
It was. Again, I apologize. If I can help you with anything, more legal and book related, then let me know. But unfortunately, apart from that, all I can say is just...
Can I go in that room? If you are with me? I'd like to look.
What do you want to look at? It's kind of... You need written permission from one of a few different people.
Oh, I do have permission from the Queen.
To go into that room specifically?
Yes. I don't have it on me. Which is not good proof, but I promise I have permission from her.
I apologize. I will have to see the proof.
A friend of mine has the note, but you have told everyone they cannot come in the building.
Yes. Then, once we have concluded business, you may even go and retrieve your friend and your permission.
How expensive are the books in there?
In there?
Yes.
In that room?
In the glass room.
Priceless, beyond comprehension.
Oh, so you can't rent them?
Not the ones in the outer layer. You could, I don't really have a pricing list, but I could contact some people and maybe find out a price, but I could imagine it would be exorbitant. The one within the glass case, you couldn't, it you couldn't rent it or buy it for any money.
What is it?
It is complicated.
I suppose.
It is speculated to be the original writing of all of the gods.
Oh. Including the gods that are no longer approved of?
Yes.
Interesting.
It is in a language that no one can understand, but it is speculated to be the design plans for the entire everything. It is like a blueprint to existence.
Okay. They'll just have that.
And have the churches been able to look at this? I suppose if no one can understand it.
So to enter the room, you need permission from. To enter the larger room, you need permission from either the queen, the king. The royal advisor, or other ways.
The
owl.
I assume.
But that is a lot harder. To enter the inner sanctum, you need a key from the king and the queen.
I don't have that much permission. I only have a little permission for the first section.
Right.
Can I go? You locked the building and you...
Oh yeah, if you made it. All locks only work from the outside and you may leave whenever you wish.
Oh. Why did you do this then?
Because I didn't know what you were doing. For all I know, you could have wanted to burn the place down or kill everyone inside. It was a... Maybe now, looking back in hindsight, maybe a bit of an over-exaggeration, but you can never know. It's better to be safe than sorry.
I kind of gesture to myself in the fact that in my illusion form, I don't have any weapons on me or anything. I'm just sort of like, I'm literally just a person that wanted a book. It's okay.
And now I feel silly for overreacting. Thank you.
Good. And I get up and start heading out of the room. Kind of shiftily looking around at the two boys, like,
Gregor, what do you do? What are you doing right now? Because you said you had a plan.
Well, it seems to be that there's no hostility. Are there any books of value within grabbing distance?
He's still stealing.
Roll, like, perception. And
okay.
Roll me a perception check and an intelligence check, because also you're not a scholarly person particularly, so it's kind of hard to guess what books are of value.
Sure. You said perception and history?
Intelligence,
right? Whoa, another nat 20 for perception?
Jesus. Oh my god.
And intelligence. And 8.
Well, that sounds about right, doesn't it? Yeah. You look around and you do notice a few very expensive looking books, but most of them don't seem to be in reach. The only one in reach that seems to be... like could be to you, because it's very hard to just gauge what books are expensive and what aren't. It's a book called The Original Bestiary. And because it says the original on the front is why you think it's probably the most expensive.
Yeah. Because this is a plan that we discussed, and if we're trying to get to the owl, Gregor has a quick moral conversation with himself and then grabs the book and then tries to slip it under his his leather armor, perhaps.
Yeah, it's fine. You like grab it and then quickly tuck it inside.
Tuck it in there.
Yes.
You see that. Because you rolled perception, so I'm going to say you just saw that earlier.
Then I give Briar a thumbs up.
Yeah, got the book.
At which point you hear behind you the chair squeak out as he's the man that you were talking to seems to like stand up and like brush himself off and then start hiding behind you.
I see it. Okay, I will I'm gonna like shake out my armor and be like, oh no. And then I grab the book and I put it back, and then I'm going to say, excuse me, is there, where would I find, a book on, music of the last 70 years?
So as all of that happens, the older man comes up and says, what are you still doing in the building? Did nobody tell you to leave?
Yes, you'd say that to me?
Yes!
Lie!
Yes!
Oh, well, I didn't know we had to leave. I was looking for a book. Where did everybody go?
All the doors are locked. Yeah. How are you inside?
Well, I was inside before the doors were loced.
You're in the bathroom.
I've just been looking for a book. What seems to be the problem?
No, it's because we're having issues. It's fine. Goodbye.
Okay.
And then he starts walking downstairs, and as he does, he goes, I'll take you to the section on music. One moment. And as he starts walking past you, he casts a small spell, at which point you start hearing some of these doors, like, open again, and the doors, like, the little blocks open, and the doors open.
I have a mechanical question about a spell.
Yes.
If I stood, and I'm not going to, but if I stood right up against... the door, right, the glass door that is locked, and I cast something like a mirror image, would I be able to get a duplicate on the inside?
I need to know the wording of mirror image.
It says three versions of you appear in your space.
Yes, but I don't think they can do anything, is the issue.
It mimics actions, so I can't actually do anything.
Like, it's an illusion, so if you went to pick some... Yes, you
could. But, like, other versions of that spell that would give more physical forms.
Maybe.
Interesting.
You have knock?
I do not have knock.
Oh.
I don't have anything that's going to make this any easier, so I was just wondering if that was something that could possibly happen.
Perhaps.
Okay.
So for the people outside, Husky, you see both this ginger woman and the old man walk towards the stairs, and then a small like heated conversation between Gregor, who you've now noticed is there because of the conversation, and the old man, and then him just walk past Gregor and the doors start opening, and you would notice that from outside as well, Foul.
I I think I have just my quarterstaff up, like, ready to smash out the glass, and I'm just waiting for, like, the moment. I'm like, I got it up, I'm looking at Briar, like, I didn't let it go. I wanted to smash glass.
Not in the library.
In the library. Fine.
That's the only place to smash glass, really. Like,
no.
It's only a perfect place to smash glass.
I'm gonna stay on the roof, though. I don't know what's going on. I'm gonna stay on the roof.
Okay. Do you follow the librarian to books, Gregor, to your music books?
Yes, only to not, I don't know.
Actually take
to continue with what he,
the lie.
Yeah, right, really leaning into the lie.
Well, like, as you follow him, he arrives at like a little stretch, and he's like, our books on music are very scarce at the moment, but if you follow this little row down here towards the end, you'll find our complete library on music from both Citadel and the other areas.
Okay. Lovely. Thank you for that. I will go and take a look.
And then as he walks back to his desk, you obviously start heading outside? Or no?
Can I message Gregor while he's having this interaction?
Yeah, you'd have to go and like eyeshot of him though.
I just sort of like quickly walk past the bit that they're in, and I want to be like, can you leave the letter from the queen in between the books and then walk away?
Yes. I go down to the books, I leave it in the book, Lost Music of the Gilded Age. It'll be on page 78.
Okay. And then I'm going to kind of just wander around a bit until he's moved away from there.
People start filling back in.
And then I'm going to move to there and get the letter back in.
Yeah, sure.
And then when I get a chance, I'll go over to the librarian guy again, Albert, and be like, actually, I totally forgot. It was in my bag the whole time. And I pull out the letter and sort of show it to him.
Alright, so you pass him a sealed letter.
Mm-hmm. I don't want you to open it, please. But the seal is there.
I'm aware of how this works, thank you. I don't have proof for this particularly, but do be known if you damage anything or commit any heinous crimes in general, not in particularly in a situation, but in general, then the crown is notified if you use the seal to gain access, and then it is between you and the crown about what punishment you would face. Yes?
Yes.
All right. So you want to see inside of the antechamber?
I do. I just want to see what you have in there.
All right. And he leads you back upstairs.
Make eye contact with Husker as I'm going back up.
I raise it back up again.
He puts his hand on like the glass wall, and as he does, a little glass, like a little line frame, like just emanates from the door, in the shape of a door, and then he just pulls his arm back, and as he does, the door opens.
How do you do that?
Magic.
Is it focused specifically on you? Is it like...
So whoever is the librarian at the time, which has been me for a long time now, will have the magical circuit recognized by the wall.
Cool. And nobody else can get in?
Not really.
I'm gonna just kind of do a, as much as he'll let me, do like a lap around and take a glimpse at what books.
He doesn't let you touch any of the books, but as you walk around, there seems to be a lot of like original, very old books on the history. Specifically, there is one copy of it's called, oh, what's it called again? It's called the Elv.
That was me.
The Elvish History. Just on the stem. Then there's a few more. There's generic books, like very old, like classic, like fiction books. You know, like a few, like from a few famous authors that you've heard of. But nothing really that stands out apart from the Elven History book and obviously the one in the middle. But then there's also another book called. It's not called anything. It's on the spine. It's got EB.
EB.
Yeah.
What is this one? He does not have a title.
I actually don't know. One moment, and he like puts on he like takes a small pair of leather gloves out of his like pocket and puts them on, and then pulls it out. And as he pulls it out, his hand like passes over the spine as he like pulls it out, and the letters change from EB to EC.
Strange.
He doesn't seem to notice, and as he opens it, and he shows it to him, it's blank. And he's like, he's flipped for a few pages, and like looks for more of them, and doesn't seem to. Maybe it's just an old binding technique. We keep things that aren't particularly here for the contents, but for the history of the object itself. I could requisition more information from the Crown if you were interested.
No, I mean, I would like to touch it myself, but I doubt you'll let me, so just have a look.
What persuasion?
Mm-hmm.
Persuasion, right?
Mm-hmm.
Offer book.
He pulls off one glove while still holding up the other one and hands it out to you. Mm-hmm. It's a bit tight fitting as you put it on, but and he like gently passes it over to you. No, only with the hand that has the glove.
Why?
Because it's a very old book. It's just protocol in her.
I hold it with that glove, and I sort of like look over it to see if there's anything I notice.
Well, as you grab it, it doesn't seem to change. You look at the spine again, and the spine says EC again.
Okay.
But nothing really happens when you're grabbing it this way. You flip through the pages, and all the pages are still blank.
Can I subtly, like, just sort of almost drop it and have to catch it with my other hand to make my other hand touch it?
Show me
love it.
It's a good play.
Fine.
Oh, no.
You go.
Oh.
Oh no! And then you like drop it and grab it again. You do manage to make contact though. It's just you'll have a different response.
Okay. Yeah.
And in that moment, many images flash on your vision. Like you lose total perception of the area around you, and a lot of many different images just flash into your vision one after the other, like a slideshow going too fast. And then you come back, but you don't quite manage to perceive any of them because they flash so quickly.
So
and then the book in front of you has very faint, too faint to really perceive in the current situation, green writing on the pages. But as you notice that and can't really read any of it, the librarian snatches it back off you and closes it with a gloved hand and gently puts it back on the shelf. You must leave now.
I give him that.
Takes the glove.
I will. So, I'm sorry. And I sort of just back out and head out of the room. I want to try, if it's possible, while I'm walking out, while it's still fresh in my mind, to try to recall what was on the page and see if I could even remotely remember.
Roll like an intelligence check with disadvantage. It's like incredibly faint. It's like writing on a white page with like a very light grey pen.
Yeah.
It was very hard to perceive.
12.
No, yeah, you're not really.
That's all I think about on the way out. Like, I completely forget about our whole plan and just walk out and look for everyone. I, like, kind of gesture as I'm leaving. I look up at Husker and sort of give, like, a... And then same to Gregor when I walk past. I sort of just do, like, a...
Mm-hmm.
And head on out.
Husker's still outside.
Yes, Thal, what are you doing?
I would have placed my faith in them. I figured I wouldn't be able to get in unnoticed, so I figured
okay.
Best not to try.
So you've been mulling around. So because you're outside, You notice that only like 4 or 5 people actually head back in. A lot of them are still having these small conversations out in the like this courtyard area. And you actually notice. Roll me perception.
Are you here? 5.
Yikes.
5. You actually don't notice anything for a little while, but right as they're all about to exit, so I'm sure Gregor and Briar both exit around the same time, but obviously not together. Husker, do you head down from the top?
Yeah, I want to land like right next to those guards and be like, "What's all the big fuss about?" I want to heckle a little bit.
You just get totally ignored at this point. The two guards start heading back inside as people outside who have been shouting and arguing with them the entire time continue to shout and argue with them, but they're just done. They just start walking back inside.
That's fair.
But as they're all exit, you're the first one to still notice, Val. You feel that crackling feeling again. The fins and the spines all over. Not the fins. No, those fins. You have fins in this one. Sorry, the fins on your side like sort of stand up on end and. It feels like you've been like had just like a small electric shock, and then everyone else, one by one, you start to feel this as well. The hair on your arm standing up on end, as you feel the vibration.
Oh no!
Get everyone out of here. Senses.
Yes.
Guards, you want to get everyone out of here.
And we will give me 1 second whilst I move us to a different page.
Guards.
Screaming guards won't help. Right now.
I need an alleyway very quickly.
Gods.
I'm God.
God.
Gods.
Okay. I need an alleyway. Please.
Let's transition this over.
And then get out of here.
I'll try to like make myself really big in front of Briar so she can like, you know, change.
We're like a magic duo.
Put like a feathered arm.
Very
out,
good.
Like... Yeah.
The boys just make a wall in front of
me. The boys.
And I walk out the other side like,
the boys.
Quick change.
Here comes the boy. Yeah, Google just popped up for a second right there. I literally kind of opened the turn order. Am I missing it? Is it on my screen somewhere?
I think you goobered up the turn order.
Oh, it's right here. There it is.
Okay.
It was like small, but like in the middle of all the rest of the writing. I set this all up properly because I always move it by accident. I'm a terrible person, I'm aware.
Jesus.
Okay. Perfect.
Yeah, that's it.
Dude.
What?
No, that's it.
Yeah, so, and everyone roll initiative.
To be subtle.
Lovely.
What the fuck, Joe?
What?
You're not wrong, and I hate that.
Fuck, Joe.
He'd pull us over or something.
What'd I miss?
You nasty.
Gregor and the server. Making the
yoke. Nasty boy.
Nasty boy.
Nasty boy.
Nasty boy. Where are
Let's see.
On this map.
Oh.
Okay. Okay. 1 second. So remember not to look at the stream on my camera's map because that has stuff that you guys shouldn't see. Just as a side note, not particularly right now, and I mean, yes, particularly right now, but it isn't going to impact the grand scheme of things. You guys would all enter from here. You would all sorry, you guys would all be exiting from up here where these two guards have disappeared inside. What I will do is I'll pull him over here and go for now because they will make their way back soon.
Where's my token?
Yeah, you got to put your token. I forgot to do that, which sucks because I got a 22 for initiative.
That's fine, I can just add your token on and then you can enter that in. It's all good. There you go.
Oh, please, thank you.
And then you need to drag your token in from your character sheet, so you grab your character sheet and pull it onto the screen. Joe?
Does that work?
Why would I have been standing, like, around here?
Wherever you wanted to, really. You had the time to walk around to really wherever you wanted.
This has the shade I was looking for.
Nice shade.
Sure. And that's the point, as you start feeling this feeling of the sun, it goes from like the sunny middle of the day and slowly descends into a darker, you know, 1 second, I totally set this up and forgot to use it, so I'm going to use it right now.
We're getting a transition.
We are, we're going to go from send to back. Oh, it goes from this sunny light exterior And then as you start feeling this vibration, this tickle, this like prickling, emanate more and more and more. The skies darken and clouds gather above your head, swirling into this mess of what feels like fields of clouds, and the sky goes dark. And then we go here. Now we're here. There we go.
Gregor, you'd be up next to Husker and I.
So, Gregor, your original one was 9. So let me change up to 3.
Yeah.
There you go. Then, let's do a tiny bit of setup. So whilst we're doing that, how's everyone feeling?
I'm feeling fab.
Yeah, feeling fab.
Pretty good.
Feeling French.
Angry.
Feeling French.
Feeling French.
I'm feeling French.
No, you don't. You're out of French for. Get out of
this. I am French for the moment.
No, please.
Please, no.
Not please. The French.
Briar just only stays in French form for the rest of the game.
We like the French here, okay?
I'm never changing. This is me.
Oh, nice. Not to that. Sorry.
Oh,
nice. Oh, nice. You're gonna stay French.
Oh, you're French.
And then finally, where is he at? There he is.
Where is more notebooks?
Wait, does
this happening?
Look, it's the same. Awesome. So as you guys are stood around, that didn't save any of those initiatives, did it? That's tragic. I'm gonna cry. No, that one's. They all roll really well.
They're all gonna kill us before we get to this.
Did they really? Descending.
Awesome. So, as you guys step out and you feel this, you hear the as these tears in space rip open, and crawling out from them is a very three of them, four portals, all actually flanking in the full directions away from the fountain in the middle. I feel the word fountain. North, east, south, and west. The four directions you see these small portals open up, and crawling out three of them is a very familiar kind of demon, one with large wings and spines covering its entire body. Specifically, let me read out a description for you. I can't prepare to do it.
All you need to read is this bitch.
It flies.
That's your job.
Its body and tail bristling with spines, some of them falling off but then reforming very quickly. Its small stature but large black lifeless eyes crawl out with these incredibly large bat-like wings. Three spine devils crawl out of the portals. Three. Let me move them to the right layer. Each of these commoner tokens above you guys, well, next to you guys, by the way, signifies 5 commoners.
Oh, okay, so little groups of...
Sorry, 4 commoners. 4 commoners.
So there's civilians to save.
Each of them has 1 hit point, just so you know.
No! Fucking hell.
So the group collectively has, like, 5 hit points.
The group collectively has 4 hit points, yeah.
Okay.
They're dead.
Let them die.
They're dead.
Yeah, if you guys want them to. And then, stepping out of the fourth portal...
No.
It's a slightly different one, one that you've not encountered quite before. It's a humanoid. It's humanoid in appearance, but with pointed ears, scaly skin, and a long tail with claws that clearly show its fiendish nature. These devils have these snake-like growths from their emanating from their chin, adorning them, that lash out randomly, shooting this small amount of like liquid out of them.
So it has like a snake beard?
It looks like this. Let me drop this into art. There we go.
He does have a snake beard.
He kind of has a snake beard.
Damn.
Hell yeah.
It looks like both Thal and Gregor.
Yeah. They're a little baby together.
Our weird distant relative.
Or your bastard child.
They added some spine devil in there for the coloring.
I'm trying to get this framed right on the screen.
We'll
do that. There we go. Okay. And
how many of these fools are out here?
So there's three spine devils and one other new one that you've met, which is aptly named a bearded devil.
Hey.
Got it.
That beard.
And we'll start from initiative. So as this devil crawls out towards the right of the screen, it immediately takes off, flying towards you guys. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Ooh, what's this movement again? I've totally forgotten. Spine Devil, info, stat block. 40, yeah, so. I think it was here. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. Okay. And as it's flying up here, it shoots out. Two attacks. It shoots out two spines. One towards Husker, and one towards this group of pedestrians next to it.
Oh no.
The one against Husker is a 13 to hit.
That's... I don't believe that's going to cut it.
Oh, I just realized that breaks
it. Let me confirm. Yeah, that does not cut it.
Okay. And then the one against the humans, the pedestrians around you, is a... 11. their AC is 10, so it hits. So as you guys are watching this, it flies out, throws two spines out. One Husker dodges out of the way of, and the other one just hits one of these commoners in the back as it falls to the ground.
Damn.
Reducing these boys to being only three pedestrians now.
Rip that guy.
Oh god.
Well, not our problem.
Okay, and that's his turn. Husker, this guy's about 15 feet up, by the way.
15 feet. Okay, I'm not wasting any time this one. I'm going to immediately wild shape into a black bear.
Nice. That's large, right?
Sorry?
That's large, right? That's a large creature?
That is a medium beast.
A medium beast, never mind, okay.
Yeah. Can I take movement after that?
Yeah.
I'll just move here. I'm just a black bear roaring and ready for...
That guy's still crawling on top.
I'm so sorry.
It's just drip change.
I'm just... My drip, man.
You just...
My drip.
Your drip do be dripping, it seems.
My drip.
Jesus. Is it your turn, Husker? That's your action and movement?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, Briar.
Okay. Let me just one real quick double check the distance on this. Why is he so short?
The math.
Okay, he's 15 feet up.
Uh-huh.
Where he is right now?
Yeah.
This guy. I'm back at diagonals.
It doesn't... What's your range?
20 feet. I'd need to be closer, definitely, but like...
I don't see why. Those are squares.
It isn't... I know there is like a whole mathematical equation to work it out, but I simply don't care. You're within 20 feet. Go ahead. Yeah.
Okay. I'm just up 15 feet on the stairs, so we're all the same.
Sure. Level. It literally doesn't matter. The only time it matters is if you're trying to hit it with a melee weapon.
Yeah. I need him to make me a Constitution saving throw, please.
Yeah.
Yes.
Da 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 da. Oh. 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 Constitution saving throw.
Yes.
Against what?
15.
Yeah, but is it poison?
Oh, no, it's one of my fancy magic spells.
That's fine.
That nobody knows about.
Constitution is a 20. Dirty 20.
He makes it, which I think just doesn't do anything that 1 second. Yeah. I mean, does he have blood? Because he's immune to it if he hasn't got blood.
No, he's got blood.
Okay.
Good to know. So you pull out a small blade, you cut your hand, and you throw your hand forward, some of these splatters of blood dripping off as you throw it forwards, and attempt to grasp hold of something, and
nothing.
You just can't quite make it.
I just awkwardly look at Gregor and then walk down the stairs.
Yes. A formidable start.
Is it your turn?
Yeah.
The next one to call out is the bearded devil, who steps out, straightens its back, and grabs its glaive. As it looks, scans the area, it sees Thal right in front of it and starts making its way over.
I see him too.
As it sprints over, it pulls out its glaive and does like a small twirl as it brings it down on top of you. For a 16 to hit.
Nope.
Yes.
It sort of like slinks off of your armor. The target.
Fell's impenetrable.
That's fine. And then as it slinks off of your armor, one of these like spikes on its beard flies out towards you and tries to stab into you. For an 18 to hit.
Yeah, shit.
For 9 piercing damage. For 9 piercing damage, and you need to make me a constitution saving throw.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Hold on, wait.
9?
9 fails. Dave, you're a green dragonborn, right?
Aye.
Which means you have resistance to poison?
Acid.
Or is it acid? I always forget.
No, I have resistance to poison damage.
Oh.
Poison.
Is it black that's acid?
Yeah, black's acid. Which means that instead you... Oh no, wait. Constitution only lose 5. So you lose... Why didn't that roll? That's so annoying. Okay, 1 second, I detail my roll is not working. 6.
Someone tells me we need to get something to get us immune to poison.
And as this lashes out against you, it creates a wound that's festering with this like black smoke just drifting off of it. And you lose 5 hit points. And the wound doesn't seem to close at all. Like even
nothing to do with poison.
No, I thought it was because it says poison, but it isn't. It's called poison, but it's not actually poison. I hate when they do that.
Fake poison.
So, as usual, like, though usually when you like, get slashed, the wound sort of closes a little bit. This one seems to be being kept open, like, as much as it can be by this sort of, like, dark smoke drifting off of it. And bleeding very heavily. Okay.
Not good.
Uh-oh. This one's gonna fly directly up in the air as well. And fire 2 spines, one at Briar, one at the civilians next to Briar. Briar does a 19 hit.
Yes.
For
put the civilian in front of you.
For 4 points of that piercing damage.
Okay.
And the civilian gets hit for. It doesn't matter. It takes 1 point, and that's enough. Like so, as these 2 spikes come out towards you, one. Hits you like in the shoulder, and the other one just goes straight through one of the pedestrian's necks as it falls to the ground.
It's a massacre.
Yikes.
And they get to move to the top of the initiative.
The civilian.
Yeah. This one 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. This one's like on the ground, but it's flying on the ground, just so you know, and it sends out 2, 1 to Husker. 1 to this civilian over here. The one to Husker is a 14 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
For, oh no, it should be technically high, but it hits anyway. So for a 6 points of piercing damage.
No, my bear.
No.
And then the one towards the civilian is a 12 to hit, which hits, which just means 1 less. Again, it flies towards you and just sort of like does a twirl, and as it does, 2 spines are loose and 1 flies towards Husker in bear form, which hits it like just in like the meaty side of the bear, and the other one flies hitting somebody directly in the leg as they fall to the ground bleeding profusely.
These people dead?
The ones that have been hit must be dead. Right, one had them one through the throat.
They have 1 HP and the lowest damage this thing can do is 3, which is double its hit points. They instantly die.
They gotta be dead.
Jeez. How many of these civilians have gone down so far?
3.
3.
I have 2 revivifies. The math doesn't add up, gang.
I don't think you have the diamonds for revivify either.
Oh, I certainly don't. A diamond or 300 GP? No, I don't.
I should have prepared Channel Repose. We could have gotten the money in that time.
Gregor, it's your turn.
All right. Let us.
Okay, we hate protective shields.
Okay. These two are still alive?
Yeah.
Commoners?
All four of those, okay. All eight of those people are still alive, yes.
Okay. Okay, I am going to... I'm going to move here, and as I move here, I'm going to say, what are you guys looking at? Leave! And hopefully they run away.
You know, because of that, uses your bonus action, but because of that, I will allow them to move now, if that's what you want.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so they use their bonus action, and they both 5, 10, 15, all eight people run inside, which we'll say, for the purposes of right now, means they're out of danger.
Okay.
Unless you guys all run inside the building as well, the fight moves inside of the building. We'll say they're out of danger for now.
Okay, then I will look at this person, this spine devil.
Mm-hmm.
And I will say... I've read books, heard songs too breathtaking for any language to describe. You, on the other hand, have an unfortunate look, one that would surely make a moldy onion cry. And I cast Vicious Mockery.
Nice, okay, what do I need to do?
For Vicious Mockery? Is it a...
Wisdom save, right?
A target, hear it. Wisdom save of 14.
Why is the onion gotta be moldy?
Oh, that just so he rolled, he rolled a 9 and a 5, which means that it was actually an 11. So yeah, he fails.
Fantastic.
Oh, good boy.
Okay, so he takes 5 psychic damage, and has disadvantage on the next attack roll it makes before the end of its next turn.
Nice. 1 second.
He might have saved some civilians.
Let me quickly give them colors. Red. Just so I can keep track of them better. Oh god, go away.
Whereas Josh likes to say pedestrians, which pedestrians. Is very funny.
Civilians.
These pedestrians.
Commoners.
It's not a roadway.
It could be. Every road is a roadway.
Transformers.
Did this guy move up to Thal to attack him, by the way?
Oh yeah, he did, thank you.
Okay, just so I know where he is.
No, yeah, I appreciate that. I totally forgot that. Red. Green and blue. So then that would be red. Lost. How many hit points was that? Five.
Five. Yeah.
So that was okay. Awesome. So that's your turn, Gregor.
That's my turn.
Nice. Val. This bearded boy just walks up to you and misses you with his glaive, but manages to launch this like tentacle into your body. This tendril.
Well, first of all, I'll look over at the other civilians who are still standing there. Like, the rest of you too, get inside, it's safer.
Sure, yeah.
And then get my mates ready.
5, 10, 15, 20. They run immediately up the stairs now that you've sort of like snapped them out of this like haze that they were in for the first round. But that's as far as they can run.
Or nothing. As for the boy right in front of me, I will smack.
Swing.
Oh.
Smack.
Damn.
Nice.
Big smack.
Big smack. 8 damage, nice.
Big smack.
Nice. So you, as it runs up to you, this tendril's still in you, and you just bring out your mace, you shout over to the civilians, and then bring down your mace upon him for a solid hit of 8 damage. Is that your turn?
That's for the poison. And yes.
poison. Let me see if there's anything that you need to do really quick. Oh yeah, sorry, you died. No.
No.
Oh, damn.
Alright, that was fun.
It was a real one.
Oh, no, but actually, no joke, you do... No, that
you
isn't
do
the
die.
Right thing. You do die.
No joke,
you do
joke.
Die. You do die.
No, my bad. I actually made a mistake. You regain 5 hit points from earlier because you shouldn't have lost them.
Nice.
Okay.
But You are poisoned. You're not being a dragon, green dragon ball. You're not immune to the poisoned condition, right? Just you take resistance to poison damage.
Yeah, and this thing wouldn't classify as a disease, per se.
No, it is a poison. You are poisoned in a way that means that you cannot regain hit points.
Oh.
But at the end of your turn, none at all. But at the end of your turn, you can remake the saving throw. I read the wrong part. My bad. So you can try your constitution saving throw again.
Okay.
At the end of your turn, which you succeed. So you easily shrug off the poison.
Easy peasy.
Yes. Bad poison.
Is it your turn?
I think that signified it.
Okay. Then the Spine Devil... no, then at the top of the initiative, the civilians can run. 5, 10, 15. Also inside. Go away. Go away. Thank you. 5, 10, 15, 20. 5, 10, 15, 20. Okay. Mm-hmm. And then now it's this guy's turn. This guy is going to throw one spy. He's going to like fly slightly over here, trying to get in the way of the door. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. He's going to fly to here, but only about 10 feet out. And he's going to fire two spines, both at the civilians.
Damn it.
Which one hits, the other one hits. So two more people die.
Wait, isn't that the one that has disadvantage from vicious mockery?
Good point, yeah, thank you. The first roll would then...
Still hit.
Still hit.
The second one?
No, I rolled it just again.
Dang.
The second one... Though the second one was a natural 20, which would have taken out two of them, so you did save it from that at least, I guess.
Yay.
Down to two, so two more people die on this and just like stop frozen because they were about to get to safety, and all of a sudden this flying demon blocks their way. Okay, then it is Husker's turn.
Okay. How many civilians have been hit?
Five now, yeah.
And are these people dead on impact? Same. Death saves.
It really depends. You know what? I'll roll a general death save for all of them, just because it's annoying to roll five death saves. You can't quite tell right now. You need to take like some time to check on them. But I know at least.
Okay, but for our sake, I theoretically have at least two turns to help them.
Probably. You can guess, so.
Yeah,
I go for the two with a spike through his throat.
And, no, there is a case that some of them might be dead and some of them might not be. Depending on the way they were hit. Like, for example, the guy who got hit in the leg, way more likely to be alive than the guy who got hit in the throat.
Yeah,
that's fair. That's understandable. Okay.
Fair.
You said one of the Spine Devils is covering the ground?
Yeah, this right? one all the way over. The green one.
Green? Okay. Okay. I'm gonna, I guess, bear run under the one that is alive. Mm-hmm. I understand he makes an opportunity attack.
He's not in range.
He's not? Okay.
No.
And then I'm going to multi-attack with my big bare hands to claw. Okay. Obviously, I don't have any stats on my sheet, so... Yeah. 17 to hit?
17 hits.
Awesome. Where's my d4? Yeah, it's only a d4, sorry.
I'm angry about the d4.
For 6 points of slashing damage.
Okay.
And then put my giant beaked mouth around him, I guess, to bite.
Yeah.
For a 19 to hit.
19 hits.
Nice. I think it does. Or, max damage. 8 points of piercing damage.
Nice. So, as you run over, you sort of, like, get up onto two legs and bring down the claw as high as you can, which knocks the Spine Devil to the ground, and then you bear down it with this sort of, like, half-beaked maw with a few small teeth within it, down onto it, clamping down, ripping out, like, a sizable chunk from, like, one of its wings. It seems it's already looking pretty bad. It was fine a second ago and now it looks pretty rough.
Nice. Well, I'm a bear, so that's all that I can do. I'm gonna stay okay. Right here.
Briar.
For the first time ever, I'm gonna pull out my longbow.
Okay.
Oh, whoa.
Which, because I'm in disguise, you have a bow. Just appears.
Yeah. because you're still disguised, you take a turn. I assume you're gonna shoot the one behind you?
Yeah, I'm shooting the one that just flew up here.
Yeah. As you turn around, you pull a bow out from nowhere. And as it exits your, like, you know, the small illusion covering you, it forms and...
I'm gonna give Gregor a wink while that happens, just because okay. I feel cool.
You give him a wink as you do it. In one flush movement, you let go, you loose your arrow and...
And fingers crossed.
Yeah, hit! As you loose your arrow, you hear... fly past you, Gregor, as this arrow spirals through the air between the two sets of civilians. Planting a not incredibly bad, but solid hit on the spine devil that's currently blocking the entrance.
Can I just...
I pull out my notebook and, like, write a quick song lyric, and from the ether she pulled a bow, and I put it back in my pocket.
Not the time.
Can I use the equivalent of my bonus action to just really loudly whistle towards it, like, do the whole fingers in the mouth?
Intimidation?
Yeah, I'm trying to get it to focus.
Well, intimidation.
On. I'm so scared. Wow.
Intimidate. Are you intimidated by me?
13. Am I scared?
Are you slightly intimidated by me?
Am I scary?
Am I scary to you?
As you pull up your hand to whistle, it seems to look at you and then go back and as you move your hand, something about your hand, even though you're under illusion, something about your hand, it's all like starts to look away and just locks back on you again.
Huh.
Shit.
So you know, it worked.
I see.
is it your turn?
Only one located.
Yeah, my turn.
The bearded devil is gonna make another attack against Fal over there. Fal does a... What's my modifier here? A 22 hit.
Holy moly.
I'm afraid so.
This time, as you're sort of, like, shrugging off the poison and getting yourself, like, back ready again, you're not quite expecting the glaive that comes down in front of you, this long spear tip with this black smoke emanating off of it, and it hits you for 12 slashing damage. Jeez, as it bears okay. down your body. And then he's making me a constitution saving throw.
Natural 20.
You're fine.
Yes.
As it bears down your body, the scales kind of reduce most of the depth of the cut, still damaging quite a bit, but not quite allowing it to get deep enough to cause any major injury. That being said, as that happens, you look back up at him as this tendril fires from his face towards you for a 14 to hit.
Nope.
Nice. And then just, like, smashes off your metal armor. That's its turn.
Val's doing just fine. Hang in there, Val.
This spine devil that's higher up is going to send one spine towards Briar, one spine towards Gregor. So Briar does a... Let me make sure. Does a 10 hit?
No.
Gregor does a 7 hit?
No.
Okay. Nice. It seems very frustrated about that, and we'll circle a bit closer, but also love higher. Now it's 20 feet up.
Just looking down at us.
I see. Okay.
This spine devil is going to make a... First of all, as you run towards it and you hammer it down, it looks up at you, specifically Husker in your bear form. As you're looking down, it looks up at you and goes to bite your leg, which is right next to its head, for a 16 to hit.
Yeah.
For 2d4, so 5 slashing damage. And then, once it's bitten into you and you're like knocked off balance a little bit, it tries to bring its fork up from the side and stab you in the side of the body, for a 9 to hit.
No dice.
As it brings up to try to hit you, you sort of like just turn and knock its arm back down again. Not quite making enough purchase to do any damage. Gregor.
All right. Sal, how are you doing?
All good.
Thumbs up. Okay. Very good. I want to.
All right. Very good.
Very good.
Yes.
Very good.
Is this all right?
Now.
No bleeding.
Long. What's the range of this? Okie dokie.
Blood. For sure.
Can I target a specific person with sleep, or is it a range?
Sleep is an area. It starts with the person with the lowest health, and then makes its way up.
Can I see just that one guy in the range?
Yeah, let's see.
Blue or red, you probably could.
20 feet on a point, and that's 90 feet.
Let's check out
can
sleep.
Can I do... Is it here?
Were you trying to sleep?
Trying to sleep. I want to sleep, if I can, the Spine Devil and... No, sorry, the Beard Devil and the Spine Devil here.
You could pretty easily put it into a position where it would only hit the Spine Devil and the Beard Devil.
Okay, then that is what I choose to do.
Okay, roll your 5d8.
Alright. Rockabye baby.
Heck yeah.
Rockabye baby, rockabye. 18. I'm not saying that wouldn't work, but it does. 8. Okay, as you send over your sleep, the... Spine Devil that's currently on the ground, as it tries to stab you and you knock its arm back down, Husker, it just goes and then falls asleep.
Okay.
Though the Bear Devil isn't affected whatsoever.
He's vibing.
Because you don't quite make it over his hit points.
I don't. I see. Okay. Then as a bonus action, I will look at Thal and say, Thal, my friend, you're looking good. Give you finger guns and you have Bardic Inspiration.
Ooh, thank you.
Looking good.
Looking good, buddy.
Oh.
Looking good.
Is this Gay Warrior Dance Mark 2?
Could be.
It's all Thal needed.
Okay, yeah, you got your inspiration.
How much is that again? Like,
that's a D6, I believe.
Yes.
It may have gone up, though, I'm not sure.
I think it's still a D6. Let me... third level.
Fifth level.
Yeah, then it's... Tell me what it is.
let me check. Let me see if I can find it.
Tell me.
Tell me what it is!
It'll be her.
Bardic Inspiration.
D8.
Yeah.
Is it a
D8? D8,
ooh. Look at you.
As of reaching 5th level, unless you've multi-classed already.
Not good. D8 is what you have.
Wonderful, thank you.
You're also a Font of Inspiration.
Yeah.
Which means that you get your inspiration back on a short rest, rather than just a long rest.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm so inspired by you, Gregor.
Is it your turn, Gregor?
That is my turn.
Okay, Thal.
Mr. Inspiration.
I'm feeling good, Gregor.
Feeling good.
That's why I bring the base down again.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
Oh my god.
21 hits.
I'm gonna put a little something into it.
Oh.
This man's gonna feel the wrath of God.
Oh dear.
Smite this hoe.
I will.
This pen doesn't work.
My dude's a fiend, so it's like 3d8.
Yeah, it takes an extra d8 as well.
What?
God said, screw the fiends.
Damn. So, that's quite a bit of damage. As you bring down your mace, you first of all hear a crack of bone as it breaks into its shoulder. But then you feel the ground below you crack a little bit more as these very thick vines fire up, just slamming into its body, piercing all the way through cleanly to the other side, one, two, three, four, I'll just slam into it from the ground and then slowly dissipate behind as it fades the smite, dealing quite a bit of extra damage.
So sick.
Thanks, God.
Is it your turn?
I believe it is.
Nice, well done, dude. That's quite a bit of damage.
Civilian.
That's a lot of damage.
That's a civilians. Lot of damage.
Get your ass out of here.
These civilians are going to try to run away 5, 10, 15, 20. We're going to take an attack of opportunity.
Bitch.
They don't have access to the disengage action, but it misses anyway. So as they run away, it tries to bring down its like fork towards them, but they part like the Red Sea, and then these ones also run this way 5, 10, 15, 20 to her. Okay, civilian's done. The spine devil up here looks up, and rather than making an attack, lets out this like. Which point the other two spine devils turn to look directly at Briar.
What the fuck? What? I just touched some goo.
And then this one moves 20 feet to be in melee range, but doesn't actually hit you. Husker.
To touch the hell goop.
Why?
It's your fault. It's your fault.
We could have avoided half the campaign.
I know.
We could have avoided half the campaign.
Avoided, that's mean.
God damn it.
How's it going?
It's good, it's me. It's me. So they're focusing on her.
Yeah, this guy in front of you seems like very
asleep.
Asleep.
He's unconscious.
Oh yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, he doesn't look towards you. He doesn't hear that. Looks good, like. Good point, thank you. So he doesn't look towards her because he's unconscious.
He's asleep. The other two are very interested in Briar.
Yes.
Gregor's over there.
The bearded devil.
That was...
Yeah. Can you roll me a perception if you want to know that specifically?
Sorry. Continue.
Let's go.
Well, and I got five civilians that are dead or close to dead.
You do.
I'm gonna drop wild shape. And that's a bonus action, right?
Wow, let me check.
I'm pretty sure.
I think it's an action to take it and then a bonus action.
Just a quick check, no worries.
Yeah.
Druid.
Just a quick check.
You automatically revert if you can revert from a normal form early by using a bonus action. Yeah.
That's what I will do.
Okay, so you return to Husker form.
Husker form.
I'm gonna stay right where I am, but
you don't notice anything.
This is a weird question. Can I use two bonus actions? Because that's like a lesser action. Instead of using an action, can I use a second bonus action?
I'm gonna say. In this case, sure, usually no, because like it's just the way it's balanced. I've always thought it was stupid though, so we're gonna do a trial run to say sure, and then if I think it's too overpowered, then we'll change it. But for now, yes, you can substitute your action for a bonus action.
Thank you. I would like to heal one of the civilians. Probably, if there's someone who looks really hurt, but I'm still convinced they're alive, I want to use healing word at a first level.
Like,
well, the ones that I remember, I said one of them got hit in the shoulder.
Yeah.
One got hit in the head. One got hit in the neck. One got hit in the leg, and I think one of them just got hit like in the body. So you got like you put shoulder, body, leg is probably your best options there.
Yeah. You could
gamble the neck. The neck still might be savable, but head's definitely gone.
Head's toast. But here's the thing, shoulder, leg, they can probably hang on for a little bit longer. I'm gonna gamble on Mr. Neck. Head, we're gonna consider him dead. Mr. Neck, I'm gonna give that a shot. Healing word at first level, it's just a few points, but he didn't have very many to begin with.
Does he live?
So,
doesn't really matter. You know, as you throw out your spell towards him, when he hit the ground, it forced a spike out of his neck. Because like he fell backwards and the spike was forced upwards, It's still partially in his neck, but you hear like as he's not moving because he's still like got like the front wound couldn't close because there was still a spike in it, but the wound on the other side did. So right now the spike is actually keeping him alive. Funnily enough.
Nobody touch him.
But he's not moving. I will. You know what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put like another token specifically for him. He was over here. I'm gonna put like a little. I'm just gonna put like an X on it. Oh, not an X because that's usually bad.
Yeah. I'm keeping track of the injuries and he's alive.
So he's alive still, but
struggling.
Well, and that's a good start.
Probably won't be able to move either. Just for a side note, for a little while. Is that your turn, Hester?
I'm just gonna stand next to that pool. Okay. Actually, I'm gonna put myself right here. I know I just entered his melee range, but this is where I want to be.
Okay, that's fine.
Wait a minute.
I need to check something really quickly. Sleep. Do they get a check at the end of their turn, or is it just when they get woken up?
I think it's just being awoken.
Sleep is...
Or perhaps there's a certain amount of damage.
I think if they get hit, they wake up. It's
yeah.
Falls unconscious until the spell ends.
Until the spell ends, the sleeper takes damage or someone uses their action to shake them or slap them awake. Okay, cool.
He's just having
otherwise, he's
just
having for a minute.
Cool. No problem. Awesome. That's all your turn. Briar.
So, the guy in front of me is damaged because I shot him with an arrow and
yes.
Something else hit him. The blue guy is not hurt?
Blue guy is actually not hurt at all yet, no.
And green guy's asleep?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna use my equally fancy cantrip, which does nothing right now, but if I take damage, he has to do a constitution save.
Okay.
But I'm focusing it on him, so he's basically the equivalent of Hexed, just now.
Because it's just on him, though.
Just on him.
Okay, no problem.
Just on the red guy.
So you, again, you squeeze your palm, which you had this cut already, and a bit more blood drops out, and you throw it at him, and it sprays over him. It sort of dissipates as it seeps into his body, and he is under the effect of a spell. For now.
It's really all I can do because he's right next to me, so...
Is that a range spell or is it just like a choose for somebody?
It's just choose a
okay,
creature.
So. Okay, so is that your turn?
Yeah.
Dave!
Oh. Lay it on me.
Oh, fuck. Damn, that was a good roll as well. Okay, does a 18 hit?
Yes, it does.
Okay. For a 7 slashing damage.
Okay.
And you make a constitution saving throw.
I would like to use the inspiration for that.
Okay.
To try and shake it off.
Okay, so a total of 11.
I'm not feeling good, Gregor.
As this glaive rips down you, this time it hits in the exact same place as the last one did, allowing it to go way deeper and getting maybe a bit too deep for it to be comfortable. Not that a glaive hit would ever be comfortable, but you know what I mean. And you feel this smoke seep into you and into your wounds. You take an extra 1d10, so 8 points of... you just lose 8 hit points. 8 pure damage.
Pure damage.
These shoots are tough.
But not until the start of your next turn. So...
And I have what?
Not until the start of your next turn is when you take that damage. So...
Oh.
Don't worry about it right now. I didn't read that part. And then as that happens, the beard fires out towards you for 11 to hit, which I don't believe hurts.
No.
Okie dokie. Not you. It's the Spine Devil's turn. This one's going to make a shot against Husker. Actually, no, it's not. No, it's not at all. It's going to fly down and make a hit against Husker. For 12 to hit. And then a 11 to hit. Okay, cool. That shouldn't have done that. So it's down at your level. And it swoops down to try to... it bites you up first and then swings back around with its trident trying to stab you. Misses both, which is 15 down. And then it's going to fly 15 feet back up on this direction.
Shit.
So it swoops down, does two attacks, and then swoops back up.
Yeah. Punk.
Yeah, what a punk ass bitch.
Which is its turn. Then the one that's asleep is napping.
We keep sleeping.
Gregor.
All right. Here's what I do. That's a bonus action, right? Okay. I'm gonna give. Husker, you look like you've been hit a little bit too much today. So if you can. Just, you know, pick yourself up as much as you can. I'm gonna cast a healing word at...
Don't do that. I only lost damage in bear form. So I'm actually right as rain. I believe
Well, Gregor, we'll say that you notice that he actually hasn't been hit at all in his normal form, which means he hasn't taken any damage yet.
Yeah, I'm good to go.
Oh, sorry, I meant Thal. Did I say Husker?
Yeah, you did.
Okay.
Thal could use that.
Thal sorry, could use the help, yeah.
The fog of battle and all.
Sure.
He said healing word,
can you... There it is. You get five healings.
Ooh.
Five healings. And then... Let me just reduce that thing. And then towards the, this is 40 feet, lovely. Okay, I'm going to, I'll look at the bearded devil and I'll try to mimic the whisper that he did. So I'll just go, and I do dissonant whisper on him.
Well, I whispers with whispers.
Whispers dissonant with whispers. Whispers. He needs to make a wisdom saving throw of 14.
Okay. He succeeds. Like.
Damn it. Okay.
Wisdom saving throw? Yeah, like a 16.
Okay. I was gonna do it. So on a failed save, he takes half as much damage. And doesn't have to move away. So, that is...
Half to seven. Eight.
Yeah.
Nice.
Okay, and that is my turn.
Awesome. You whisper out and these wisps of words wrap around him, constricting parts of his body, and he just sort of, like, breaks out of them, causing him to take a bit of damage, quite a bit. Everyone remember to say what level of spell you cast before you cast a spell. Just for future reference. No, it's not a big deal. If he succeeded anyway, so.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's your turn, right, Gregor?
Yes, it is.
Thal, beat this man.
I really do appreciate it, Gregor, but I think you should focus on the others. They might need your help a bit more.
Oh, damn.
All right.
Oh,
thank you. And
King Shirai,
I'm gonna put an end to this man.
Put an end to this man.
King Shirai.
Nice.
Even
just
though
looking
that...
out for my fellow green
actually, you... Wait. Can I ask how hurt is he looking?
I'm gonna put an end to this man.
Tell.
He's fine.
He's actually not looking that bad right now.
Damn it.
He is not yet blooded.
Hubris.
Let's put a bit more into that then, shall we?
Wait a second, Dave, you take 5 points of damage from your wound at the start of your turn. And then, so 10 points of bludgeoning, okay?
So the stuff that he healed, he lost again.
Didn't you say 8 before?
It was 8. We'll just call it 5 for now, it doesn't matter, I won't go back and check yet. Just take the 3 hit points, Dave.
Take the heal.
Okay. Trying to keep it fair.
Don't look a gift DM in the mouth.
Okay, so you bring down your mace for a solid hit, as this wound is bleeding profusely in front of you. What, is that your turn?
I did want to put one more smite into him.
Go ahead.
Do it. End this man.
Pop off.
Smite this guy.
Hoping these vines come and drag him back down to hill.
Power of God and anime.
Okay. After that attack, after you land that hit, instead of coming from the ground this time, the wood staff of your, like, the wooden handle of your maze sprouts with these wrapping vines that cover the maze and cover the impact site, dinging these really sharp thorns which rip through the armor and the skin of the bearded devil like a whip. Like, and as you drag it down, they just cut clean across his skin. And actually he does fall to the ground, not dead, but very injured. Very injured. Very bloodied now, I'm going to say, after that attack.
Love it.
Truly is going to end this man.
Truly. Mm-hmm. But is that your turn?
It is now.
Okay. Top of the initiative, these guys are going to 5, 10... 15,
get
20.
Out of here.
They're running! 5, 10, 15, 20. Chill, they're running, okay?
Not fast enough.
And then he's going to throw two spines at... No, he's not. He's not going to throw spines because he's too close. He's going to try to hit you.
Me?
Yeah. For a 20 to hit, a dirty 20.
That hits.
And a 19 to hit.
That hits.
Okay.
Need him to make two constitution saves because he hit me twice.
Okay, 1 second. Let me do that first. First one is a 16.
16 what?
Constitution save.
Oh, yeah, that makes it.
Yeah. The second one is a 9.
Doesn't make it, okay.
Okay, what happens to the second one? Do you need no damage first?
I need to no damage, yes.
Okay. Well, the first one with a bite, so he goes in with a bite, dealing 3 points of damage. And then the second one, as he's bit into you, like he's like currently got like these like sort of dimorphodon like jaws on you, he just brings in his fork and stabs you through the center for 4 points of damage.
You know what's annoying? Because he succeeded, the spell ended before the second one.
Oh, that sucks.
So, never mind.
So instead, he brings a fork through you for 4 points of damage. Are you okay still?
Stop picking me up by your fork. I don't like it.
Is it that's
not a snack.
Not a snack.
Husker!
Okay. Is Red airborne?
Red is not. Red is on the ground now.
Okay. I'm gonna cast another healing word at first level on the civilian who got hit in the torso and the body. That seems a little more dangerous.
Let me roll him some. Oof. You throw out your healing word towards him, and nothing makes contact. But the spell slot is used.
Damn it. So we lost two so far. One is hanging in there. And then he got a shoulder and a leg wound. If you can't survive a leg wound, you're a pussy. You guys gotta hold it.
There's some pretty important arteries in your leg. Let's not forget that.
Yeah, okay. Damn it. Damn it. Alright.
It doesn't seem to make contact. He actually rolled a 6 and a natural 1, which is 3 failed death saves. Man was destined to go.
Damn.
Alright. Fine. And then I'm gonna cast... I guess I'm gonna cast Earthbind on blue.
Okay.
He needs to succeed a strength saving throw.
Ooh, they're not very strong.
I figured not.
10.
No.
Okay, so what happens?
His flying speed is reduced to 0, and he's going to descend at 60 feet per round until he reaches the ground or the spell ends. I really hope that means he crashes into the ground.
Let's
you may interpret that as you wish, but he has no flying speed and is descending 60 feet per round.
Earthbind. Yellow strips of magical energy loop a creature.
That is concentration.
No, it does say an airborne creature safely descends at 60 feet per second. Ebert per round,
I don't see the word safe. Not the one I'm reading.
You know what? We're gonna go to the granddaddy of everything. If it says in 5e tools safely descends, then we'll rule it that way. Let's see. Air spell, so it was Earthbind. This is how we do it in this book, because I don't have the spell cards on me right now. Earthbind. The target must succeed a save throw is reduced to zero. An airborne creature affected by the spell safely descends at 60 feet per round.
Alright, fine.
It is bound to the earth now, so its flying speed becomes zero, so these lashes of yellow energy fly out from your hand and wrap around its wings, binding it together and pulling it to the ground.
Up to me.
Does it mean they're grappled?
No, it just can't fly away.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's actually quite a useful spell, especially when you're a bunch of melee fighters fighting a winged creature.
Yeah, I don't want him to get away from me right now.
Is it your turn, Husker? Sure.
I'm actually gonna move forward to enter his melee range again now that he's on the ground. But yeah, that is my turn.
Briar. You're currently being impaled by a fork.
That sucks.
Magic Michael. Sure, what's the damage? Are you just doing the first level?
Yeah, I'm just doing a first level.
Roll me damage.
Four nine. That was 2 GM. That's the first one, which is 2 force damage.
You have 2 force damage?
It's 3 at the moment, so 2, 2, 4.
Okay. As he impales you with this trident and pulls it out because he can't actually keep it in you, as he pulls out at the end of your turn, following the three holes that he made, three of these dark red crimson magic missiles fire out of your wounds, striking him for a decent amount of damage. This one's against red, right?
That's 8, yeah.
Against 8 against red, so nice. Poo, he seems very weak, but still standing.
I think that's all I have, let me double check. Oh, and then I'll summon my my shadow blade again. From
the darkness around you coalesces into a blade.
I'm staring him in the eyes to scare him.
Okay.
Spook him.
Dave, hi dude, how you doing? How you feeling today?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling great.
Yeah.
Chat.
Yeah. Well, that's amazing. That's awesome.
How about you?
I'm feeling pretty good. Let me just get up the stats for the bearded devil real quick.
Are you still gonna feel good after the amount of hurt you're gonna lay on me?
We'll see. We'll see. Okay.
You will.
Smackdown.
So.
You will.
His first attack is a 23 to hit.
Oh my god.
Jesus.
As you're stood there next to him, you just bring down that hurt into him as you rip down his chest with these gnarled vines as they dissipate. He looks up at you, murderous intent in his eyes, but a bit of weakness, like you can see his wounds are bleeding very badly and he's sort of like panting for breath. As he flourishes his glaive, he brings it down upon you for a 7, only 7 points of slashing damage.
Only 7? Okay.
Yeah, and that's that part. The next part is after he brings that down on you, his beard fires out towards you for a 23 to hit again.
Keep control of your beard, sir.
I know, right? What the fuck, dude? For 6 points of piercing damage.
Okay. Yeah, this dude's spear control is a little too good for my taste.
Spear control? Ew, right. I hate it.
And if you survive that, I need you to make me a constitution saving throw.
Survived that. 15.
You're fine. You're not poisoned.
Can you imagine being able to move your beard just freely? Like, just control it.
I'm making do waves.
Hi.
Hello. Oh my god.
Hello. Spined boy. One spiny boy is currently landlocked. He's gonna make a bite attack against Husker, who moved into his range for like a 7 to hit and a 4 to hit. Cool. Kind of like he's a bit off balance. Like he goes to flap towards you to bite you, but as he flaps, he doesn't move at all, and he bites the air, and then he brings his fork out. And you're already expecting the round of attacks at this point, so you just dodge out of the way as he goes to hit you with his trident, and you know. He misses both attacks. That boy's still asleep. Grigor!
Sweet dreams.
Nice. I'm inspired by Briar's, weapon use. So because this... Actually, how high in the air is this?
He's right next to it.
He just pulled
5 feet. Yeah, he's right into you. He's into both of you.
Right.
Fantastic. Love it. Pod me. Do you mind holding my axe? And I swing at it.
Excuse me, sorry,
pardon
me.
Yeah, sure.
Do you mind holding my axe?
No, wait, what do you mean?
Sure did.
18.
You say, hey, do you mind holding my axe? And bam, you plant your axe right in between his shoulder blade and his neck as it goes, and it doesn't stop going until it reaches right through him. Sort of like severing his upper torso from his lower torso as it slides off. You eviscerated this creature.
I think it might be just
Gregor has a little. He has a little bit of a panic because this is Gregor's first life that he's taken with a weapon.
Whoa.
Oh, okay.
Whoa.
So he's kind of wide-eyed. I did it. I did it. What happens now? What should I do?
We'll kill the other ones and then we can celebrate.
Okay.
Focus on the civilians, Gregor.
Can I just like pat his
right.
Calm him down a bit.
Okay, let's see, what else should I do here? I think that'll be my turn, because I think I'm a little...
Yeah, Brian reaches out and turns you in the direction of Husker and the other one.
Rotate
him. There's a man with like a neck wound standing right behind me, gasping for breath.
Thal, at the start of your turn, since you've received two large wounds from this glaive, you take 6 points of pure damage.
Okay. Is that from like... Is that from like the glaive's shadow thing, or just from having wounds?
No, that is from the wounds won't close or even like close over.
Yeah,
they're being ripped. They're actually not just being open, but being ripped apart by these shadowy hands that is allowing more and more blood to seep from your wound.
I'm not a fan of that.
Not.
But that's it's your turn. What do you do? What are you doing? How you doing? Go get him. Go get the man.
Yeah. You know what? I'm gonna end him.
End him. End him.
Yeah, not 18 hertz. So you bring down your mace and you feel the armor that this creature's wearing and the bone underneath just buckle behind the way that you're throwing onto it. Is that all your damage?
I'm so excited to just throw another vine in there.
What's up to you?
Yeah, fuck it, I'm ending this dude for real.
Okay.
End him.
He's the big one, I'll be damned if he lays a hand on those citizens. Or anyone else.
So as you bring the mace down, you make contact and you hear the cracks, but the creature looks up at you with harried determination on his face to end you first, and then as that happens, you hold your symbol for a second and you think back to your god and your people and your oath, and then out of the ground you feel a tremble as twisting out of the ground below him, a reef, a twirling mass of vines fires up from the ground directly through him, from below him, straight up the way through, spearing him all the way through the center and lifting him up 5 feet off the ground, and then it disappears as he falls to the ground dead.
Oh, yeah.
But that's your turn, I assume?
Yeah, and after that, I'm just gonna look over at Gregor, who's just gotten his first kill, and smile.
Okay.
Sums up.
That guy's dead. Husker.
Okay. I'm gonna drop the concentration for. We're fine. I'm gonna do a healing word. A healing word on Mr. Mr. Legwound.
Okay.
How's Mr. Legwound?
Let's see.
Thanks. In your Legwound.
Okay. Luckily, he rolled a natural one and then 3 successes, so he did succeed. As you throw out your healing word towards him. It nicked part of his artery, which you managed to seal up pretty well, but as part of this one, the spine sort of gets forced out as it heals. And he seems to be okay. It's still damaged, it's magically healed, so he like sort of scrambles up and starts heading off. Let me control C, control V. Let's move him over here. Like, he was here and then he goes 5, 10. I'll reduce his movement by 5 feet, there we go. He managed to get to there by the end of the turn as he smiles and like does like a, and then like starts heading in a different direction.
Oh yeah. So for the rest of you, the token behind me has a neck wound who's hanging in, and then there's a man with a shoulder wound that I just don't know anything about. Mm-hmm. So we got 2, possibly in critical condition for everyone else. But I'm just gonna cast Entangle on this guy. I don't want him going anywhere dealing more of these instant kills. So that's an entangle for me. Make strength save, please.
Nope. He failed.
Okay. he is restrained.
Okay.
I brought him back to the ground and I covered him in vines so he cannot move.
Yes.
Let's see what restrained does this again, just to remind me. I know speed becomes 0. Restrained.
Petrified, he can attempt to break out of it on his turn.
Restrained. Speed becomes 0, can't benefit from anything to speed. Attack rolls against the creature have advantage, and the creature's attack rolls have disadvantage, and it has disadvantage on dexterity saving throws. Okay. Cool. Man is restrained. Okay. Awesome.
Yeah, that's it for me. Yeah.
Mariah.
Did Green take damage
top of the turn
before he went to sleep?
Yeah, I buried him.
Okay.
5, 10, 15, 20, 5. Oh no, he yeah. And then he, yeah. So, okay, those two are off the map. I might as well just delete those. Okay. Yeah, Green did take some damage.
Bigger damage.
Can I.
Blue is still damageless, I believe.
Yeah. Can I go up to him and just, like, while he's unconscious, just stab the blade into him?
Stab him? It's an automatic crit if you hit, so just roll to hit. Give advantage.
Okay.
17 luckily hits. It's an automatic crit, so he's dead. Without the crit, he would have been dead.
Do you understand how batshit that is? I brought down this fully healthed man to the ground, I'm restraining him with vines, and you walked up to the unconscious guy and stabbed him in the neck.
Yep.
And Oscar's mad.
Who knows when he was gonna wake up, though?
Like, yeah. I brought this down for you! That one could've waited!
Is it your turn?
So that was 5, 10, 15, 20. I stab him. He dies.
He dies, yeah. Fuck.
Yeah.
He dies.
I start walking slowly over to the other one.
Okay. You know, Brian just soaked up the easy kill for her KD, and now she's going to help me.
Bearded Devil is dead. Spine Devil is alive. Yeah, she's going to fire 2 spines off towards Briar.
Come on,
Briar.
Yeah, with disadvantage. So
doesn't change anything.
17 to hit.
Jesus.
And
yeah.
12 to hit.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
You deserve this.
You deserve this.
Yeah, I'm a baby.
Yeah, you suck. I'm sorry. Your AC sucks. I apologize.
You take 9 points of piercing damage as these hit you, and then a few seconds after they hit you, I can't forget to do this, I'm doing this now. A few seconds after they hit you, they explode into fire.
Of course they do. Why wouldn't they?
You forgot that?
Yeah. They're supposed to do a whole extra d6 damage.
They've been holding off on us.
Yeah, doing an extra 7 damage. What we're going to say, as he gets pulled to the ground, his body starts to heat up, not doing any damage to the vines, but the powers of him starts to, patches of him glow, and his eyes glow, and his tail spines start to irradiate this warm heat as they two of them off towards Briar, and as they hit, they dealing. You got the damage right?
Yeah.
So 10, 16 damage altogether.
Within that one hit, I go from confidently striding to being oh fuck.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's his turn. He's dead. So, Gregor.
Good.
Lovely job there.
This is concentration. So I feel like I have vines in my hand that I'm dragging to the ground with. I'm just frantically looking at everyone, please do something, anyone.
Okay, alright. Gregor is muttering to himself, alright, the best medicine is to just try to do it again and get used to it.
Medicine.
So I will come up to this spine devil and I'm going to swing my axe at it.
Okay, go ahead.
He's off his game.
You got advantage.
I'm off my game.
You have advantage.
Yeah, he's restrained. Get it. Come on.
Back on your game.
Winner.
Shake it off. You got
winner.
This.
Just roll a straight roll again.
Did it do it twice? Oh, I'm just going to do... There we go. No, it's making me edit it. Alright, I'm just going to roll a d20. Is that cool?
Yeah, sure.
Alright, D20. So it would be 16.
Even 16, but the 13 would have hit anyway. It's just in case he got a crit.
13 would have hit.
Yeah. So okay. You bring down your war axe down onto him.
Battle axe. Sure.
Battle axe. Sorry. And you make contact. It deals damage.
There's too many vines in the way.
There is too many. The vines that are restraining it also do tend to get in the way of the axe.
Sure.
So, you still hit. Well done.
Yay! All right, now, fantastic. Then as a bonus action, I will look at Briar. Briar, it seems as though you were walking so tall just a moment ago. I'm going to... Perhaps this will help you with your posture. And I will cast Healing Word at... a level 1, just in case. 6 healings.
Healings.
I, straighten up a little bit. You can tell I'm still in pain, but I'm better than I was.
And that is my turn.
Okay. Thal, the start of your turn...
Lay it on me.
Your wounds, you feel that pulse of pain as if you feel a rip again as you take an extra 14 points of damage.
Oh.
You alright?
Oh no, I miscalculated. I thought it would be 6 again. Oh no.
And we can't hear right?
Are you conscious, bud?
You don't know that.
But I mean, out of character.
Out of character, there's no reason why you shouldn't be able to.
Fair enough.
Are you okay, pal?
You're good?
No.
No.
I'm on zero hit points.
But you're okay, you're still up.
I thought... What now?
I said you're okay though, you're still up, right?
I said 0 hit points.
I thought you said 2 hit points. Oh no.
No.
Thal, like somebody who's like, you know, got a bunch of, like, had like a life-threatening injury and then got a bunch of adrenaline, he takes one step forward after his fight and just boom, boom to the ground, and you hear a thud as he face plants the ground.
I'm coming to.
Okay, and that's that technically happens at the start of your turn, so you don't even make a death save this turn. Your turn ends. And
oh hell yeah,
Husker!
Oh hell yeah!
You see that because you're looking over towards Briar, because you just watched kill somebody. You see Thal just do that amazing display where the vines bisect this this creature, and he goes, "I'm coming!" Boom! As he hits the ground.
How do I make that pointy arrow?
You need the arrow. Ruler.
I'm gonna shoot him.
Can I just pull out a pointy arrow?
No, I'm not gonna shoot him. Would you consider that to be 60 feet still? Is he still within my healing range?
Yeah, totally.
That looks pretty rough. He's got like necrotic wounds coming off of him, right?
Yep.
That sucks. But I am holding concentration on Entangle. I probably can't. I have to sacrifice my concentration to do.
No, only just another concentration spell.
Sorry?
You can cast a normal spell without losing concentration. The only time you lose is if you take damage or you cast another concentration spell.
He's good. Good. So I'm just gonna casually turn my head and throw off another healing word at third level.
Oh damn.
Nice.
Big heals.
Yeah. I'm gonna give him a third level. So that's
bless you.
Points for your boy.
Thank you.
And your wounds, as you awaken and you like roll onto your back and you look down, the wounds knit up. The shadow dispersed.
Oh, perfect. The hands are gone.
The hands of fate have been removed.
Nice.
Okay. Is it a turn, Husky?
Yeah, that's it for me. I'm staying here holding onto the reins.
Briar, what are you doing?
I go and look at this guy. I'm gonna do my the
guy
spell
on the
I
ground.
The blue guy.
Okay.
I'm gonna try and do the spell that I did at the start. So I need a Constitution save from him.
16.
Fucking.
Wait, Constitution?
Yeah.
17.
I'm gonna run up to him. And.
Get him.
You can still technically attack on a bonus action just without proficiency.
No. It needs to be part of your attack action.
Dang.
You can't. Well, unfortunately, I would have loved to see you try to bitch slap this guy.
I'd like smack him.
But like, unfortunately, you cannot.
Yeah. I mean, I guess. Are any of the guards around?
No.
I'm gonna real quick just not be a ginger anymore. Just gonna guess. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna like look him in the eyes and change back into me, and then just keep looking him in the eyes because I can't do anything.
Once you change to you, he smiles. Like this twisted grin spreads across this like, because it's not like a humanoid face. It's like a beaked but like made of flesh. It's not like a solid like bone beak. It's like elongated fleshy beak face, just sort of like spreads upwards like in like a bit like an uncanny like. Jack Skellington like grin.
Can I?
Like the Grinch.
Like the Grinch.
Can I experiment, or have I done too much?
Depends.
Like I literally just want to like hold up the hand that has the weird black fingers and sort of like move them around.
Yeah, no, you can. That's how you can do that as like a bonus action. You move them around, and he seems to follow them pretty readily.
I'm just like awkwardly. I look at the other two like.
But that is definitely your turn. The bearded devil is dead. The spine devil is not. Briar. It's disadvantaged still. So 13 to hit.
Yes.
He can attempt to break out of it.
He doesn't care.
He doesn't care.
She's squishy enough.
12 to hit.
12 to hit?
Yeah.
Yes, that hit.
Okay, both of them hurt. Yeah, no.
God damn it, Briar.
He's had no trouble trying to hit her, so.
Yeah, clearly.
Eight piercing damage.
Yeah.
And.
Is it more than two?
Yeah.
I'm done. Okay.
Oh my god. He rolled two max damage, which was 12 damage for the fire damage. As these two spikes shunt into you, you feel okay for a second, for the moment you forget that the fire is coming until you feel that burning sensation well up, and poof, they both explode, firing you 10 feet back against the ground.
I have a question.
Yes?
So he threw both spears at me?
Yeah.
Which took me to zero, and then they exploded.
Did it take you to zero?
If the second attack was more than two, yes.
No, so the first attack was 3 damage, and the second was 5.
Together.
8 together.
Never mind.
Well, that's technically fine. Then, if we're doing it that way, did you have 9 damage, 9 hit points?
I had 8 hit points.
In the first place?
Yeah.
Then, yes, you would have taken a failed death save.
Okay.
The first one hits you and explodes. Well, it's just for the flavor. The first one hits you and it explodes, knocking you to zero, and the second one hits you as you're in the air, exploding, dealing a failed death save to you.
Okay. I'm unconscious.
As you get thrown 5 feet back and hit the ground with a pretty heavy thud.
Mm.
Alright.
Gregor.
This.
I see.
And
I
this.
See.
Please. Healing words.
End this first, because that thing can hit her.
Yeah.
With his blindfold on.
You could deafen blind and tie this guy's tail to his leg and still be able to hit her.
Just him, right?
He's got like goop sight or something.
Goop sight.
What?
Goop sight.
Goop sight.
Ew.
Goop
the hell
sight?
Goop. He was following your fingers, right?
Yeah, I know.
Goop sight.
Oh, that's right.
Goop sight. Sounds like something Gwyneth Paltrow would sell.
He's got goop seeking missiles.
Ba-dum-bum-ba-dum-bum.
Okay, go on, Gregor.
Okay.
What's up?
I will then. I think I still just want to swing at this fool.
Let's do it.
That's what I'm gonna do.
Bada bada.
Advantage.
Add advantage. Let's see if this will.
Please.
Battle axe. Oh, that's why.
Keto.
13 hits for 7, yeah.
Okay.
Fantastic.
As you swing into it and it thuds, it doesn't seem to be getting as deep as you want it to, but it is really making contact. Like, as you hit, this like sheen of over its skin spreads and it doesn't quite make real purchase, but it does still hit and do some damage.
Okay. I'm feeling like more into what's happening right now. I'm going to look at Briar on the ground. Does Briar have to be able to hear me for Healing Word to work?
No, you can Healing Word her, but you do notice as you look over, because this wasn't really noticeable until now, as you look over to cast Healing Word, you see that she's not actually on the ground. She's slightly slung into the ground, and this black ichor surrounds her entire body as it feels like she's as it looks like she's slowly sinking into it.
Excuse me?
She's sinking!
The goo?
She's sinking! Val, get your girl.
I've got a plan.
Okay. Okay, I think I'm just still gonna do Healing Word then. Alright, Val, did you step in a puddle or something? I'm gonna cast this at level 2.
On Briar?
Briar, not Thal.
No, okay. Okay, you reach out and you go to cast Healing Word, and as you do, I need you to roll me a wisdom check for you. Oh no, you're a bard, a charisma check, sorry.
Charisma.
Oh,
right.
Okay, yeah, that's good.
18.
18 still fine. Yeah, so as you do, you see this like sort of these wisps of magical energy emanate from you, from your hand, and as they hit like a 5-foot radius around Briar, they seem to like hit a wall of like what was once invisible but now is like this dark smoke, and it feels like it's hard. It takes a few seconds, but then you feel like, whew, as it manages to make its way through this this shield and hits you, healing you for only 4 points of damage. But as soon as you're healed, the ichor and the smoke seems to just dissipate immediately, and you're back on the ground again.
So enough that I wouldn't notice that it happened.
You can roll perception. You can maybe have like caught the very tail end of it.
Perception.
Yeah, like immediately as soon as you get there, you open your eyes because you know you're in the heat, you were in the heat of combat, and you shoot up and you see this ichor just disappear in the smoke, dissipate around you.
We'll come back to that.
Is that your turn, Gregor?
Yes, that is my turn.
Foul.
Alright, now tell me if this is too much. I wanna misty step about here, go up, and try and pull Briar into like an embrace so I can like shield her, turn around, and all the while use lay on hands. Is that possible? Do I have to drop anything there?
Movement.
Thinking.
You only use 10 feet of your movement, right?
Yes.
No, so I'll say bonus action Misty Step, 10 foot of movement, yep. Reach down and pick Briar up as half of your movement rather than half of hers. Turning around and shielding her will say like 5 feet, so that's all of your movement done. You just did enough for all this. If you would have used 5 more feet, I would have said no. And then action, lay on hands.
Perfect, thank you.
Nice.
So you just immediately, you hear vroom from behind you, and then you feel your arm, you're hoist up into the air, grabbed into an embrace, and turned around away from everyone else as you feel, how many points, Dave?
15.
15 points of lay on hands.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
And with 15 points, a single flower bud appears in your hair.
Very sweet.
Very sweet.
You're not going down again.
I'm just gonna cuddle in. Okay.
Uh-oh.
Is it your turn, Thal? I assume so.
Yes. I stretched it.
Husker still just got his hand on the fucking ground.
Okay. It's me then.
Yeah, just you.
How does blue look?
It's not bloodied yet.
Not yet visibly bloodied, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Damn it. That really sucks. Can I make a melee attack without dropping concentration?
Yeah.
I'm just so fucking angry. I'm just gonna reach out and attack him with my talons.
Sure.
There's a lot of magic that had to kick him.
No, it's gotta be my talons. Or maybe my taloned foot. I just wanna hurt him for 15 to hit.
15 hits?
Okay. But not it's not gonna be a tremendous amount of damage. For 2 points of damage.
For free?
Two.
Two. Nice.
Two
half to one.
Jesus.
You reach out and you like pull your taloned hand down his face, ripping through barely like one piece of epidermis.
Jesus. I've got nothing else I can do. I'm just gonna keep restraining him.
Okay, keep concentration. Yeah. Briar.
Can I peek over Thal's shoulder? Can I like hop and peek over?
Yeah, like climb up and look over.
And cast magic missile at second level.
You reach out.
I just don't go like
She's giving a gun next to his head.
Which means I get an extra dark because I'm doing a second level. So, 4, 5, 3, 3.
So, 6, 10, 15. Nice.
That should do it.
Oh my god, that's
fine.
That's exactly lethal.
Yeah.
That's 15 damage. So, you poke your head up and you throw out your hand. Maybe a bit of like, is it all out of worry or is it like a bit out of like
a little bit
annoyance?
Hate for him.
A bit out of hate. you throw out your hand, and not the red ones like they were before, but like the classic blue bolts of arcane energy fire past your ear, Thal. Fires past Husker, who's just clawed at him. You see that claw mark that you just made? As soon as your hand moves out of the way, bam, 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 four bolts of arcane energy just batter it back once, twice, three times, and it's about to throw out its tail to throw some spines back in the direction of which the bolts came, but doesn't quite manage to get the spikes detached as poof, the fourth one hits. And it just sort of lays back there, stood in the same way it was because it's currently being restrained. So it's
just
in the exact same position, but now dead.
I immediately cower back into Thal's chest.
And that, my friends, is combat over.
I did it.
A few seconds after that happens, I all assume are just like taking a moment to recognize what's going on. Thal's hugging Briar. Husker's detaching the vines from his hand and standing back up, shaking it off. Gregor's maybe having just a moment to himself after that combat. And the clouds slowly twist and part, and the day becomes bright once again.
Fire, you want to stay here for a bit?
I just nod and then cuddle in a bit closer.
Gotcha. And I'll walk over to Gregor.
Okay.
Is there anyone still hurt? I look around for civilians.
There's one shoulder injury still.
And okay. Mr. Neck, who's kind of hanging in there.
Okay. I'll go to, I guess, Mr. Neck.
He needs help.
It is, it will be all right. You were brave today, though I imagine you probably should have exited a bit quicker than you did.
Fine.
No mind. I will do cure wounds at
do you,
a
do you pull
level.
The spike out first?
Partially.
Do I pull the spike out? Maybe I'm thinking, yeah, I think about like what I've seen done in the past, and it's they pull the spike out and like try to immediately cover the wound and whatever, apply healing. So that's what I do.
Okay, you rip out the spike, and as you do, you throw your hand back over the wound and cure wounds.
Yep.
For 11 points of healing, that's like 11 times this guy's max hit points.
This
good to know.
Feeling great.
You know, I'll say because it's such a high heal, and also because it's directly on the wound, there's not really even going to be any scarring either.
Nice.
Oh, nice. He'll appreciate that. I want to scrabble towards Mr. Shoulder to see if he's still alive, even.
Do you want to do a medicine check, or do you just want to throw a Q wounds at him? Or
it's been so long at this point that he's either survived by his own will, or he's just dead. So I'm just gonna do a medicine check on him.
Okay, roll me a medicine check.
Yeah. I want to see if it's even worth my time. Well, I'm running out of spell slots. 16.
No, he seems to be just holding on. Not in a great condition. Like there's been quite a bit of blood seep. Like you can see, like in that, like his white tunic is now crimson. He's laying like a small pool of his own blood. Like he seems to be quite like probably needs like a cookie, you know, get his blood sugar back up.
He needs a cookie. All right, then that's not a lot of first level spell slot, so he gets a second level spell slot. Healing word or just for fun, 6 points of healing.
6 points of healing. And yeah, he like you pull out the spike as well, and you throw down a healing word. I don't know if I can say that.
Yeah.
Healing word onto him, and he gets up and like grabs your shoulder and like shakes him. Thank you. Could you wait here for a moment, all of you?
Is this just like a random civilian?
This seems like he'd be important? A random guy. He doesn't seem to be important at all.
Okay.
And he like sort of like puts you down and pulls like a small flash from his side and takes a quick sip of it. And seems to walk towards like this other the group of civilians over in the corner. Sort of like walks past Gregor and asks, like, "Do you want me to take this man to the infirmary?"
Yes, if you could,
please.
Yes. And he pretty much goes around and just collects. He seems to be like the least wounded out of everyone here, like the most able to do things. So he's like he collects the different injured like civilians from around the area and like collects them all up. Leaves the one that's very obviously dead though, and walks over to this like larger group of civilians over in the corner.
We lost two, I think.
I believe you only lost one. You only lost Head Boy, right? No,
Torso Man.
Yeah, Torso Man. Yeah, never mind, two. He leaves the two though.
To be fair, yeah, we lost two.
Head Boy and Torso Man.
Head Boy and Torso Man. The duo we didn't need. No, we just need like kid and arm girl.
Like kid and arm girl.
Footless.
Ew, no, let's not be footless. Let's not do that.
Foot dude. Captain Foot.
OnlyFans account.
Footless.
Foot dude.
Captain Foot and the hand.
Nice.
Oh, thank you. The hand.
I'm gonna go sit at the fountain.
You go over to the fountain and sit down. Like, with your feet in the fountain or your feet outside of the fountain?
No, don't just get into the fountain.
Maybe you would have. Like, you're pretty covered in blood right now and scorch marks.
No.
No, you just sit with your back to it.
Yeah.
Okay. This area now is eerily quiet.
I like that.
After maybe 5 to 10 minutes, which I'm going to say you guys can also obviously talk through, but after about 10 minutes, a few guards show up, not in the blue tunics, but the Crown's Guard, and see that the situation's kind of dissipated. We'll leave it there for a second, though, and do you guys want to do anything over those, like, 5 to 10 minutes?
Great response time, assholes.
The city's pretty fucking big.
I get it, but still.
So, what happens? I look at like everybody, and maybe I just land on Thal. Thal, how many lives have you taken?
How many lives I've taken? Well,
yes.
People, none.
People, none. Okay. What about the, you know, counting, I guess, these spine devils and, I don't know, anything that was attacking you, how many lives have you taken?
Make up a number.
I think I got like 3 last time. So let's make that 4. I don't think I've killed anything else.
So, what? Things seem a bit different now. I suppose I don't know exactly what I want to say, but. Maybe we can, I don't know, chat about maybe in a few days what it's like after the first life that you've taken. It's, I don't know how my mind is made up about it yet.
You could think about it this way.
There
was a demon. It was obvious out to hurt someone. You protected civilians. You protected people. I say that's the best way you can go about it.
Yes, I suppose you're right. Okay, well, thank you. I may come to you later, and if I have any other questions.
course. Bring him. Oh, also, Gregor?
Yes.
I think you were right before. I think we should be looking out for each other a bit more in these fights. I know against that dude, I most likely would have died way before if you hadn't healed me up. But you fixed my swinging arm.
We need your swinging arm, because my swinging arm is not very reliable. But yes, we all should look out for each other. I do very much believe that. And then I go to, like, cleaning off my axe, because it's really never had any blood on it.
It's a new concept.
I know.
What's happening to the dead bodies? Is anyone attending to them?
Well, this is before the guards arrive, and no one else is right now. Is there anything to tell you want to do?
I would like to give them a little rite.
Okay.
There's, like, a funeral rite from Corellon, right? There has to be.
Yep. If you wanted to do anything in particular, you need to use the ceremony spell, but if you just wanted to be like just a rite, you can just say a quick prayer.
It's a rite. Perhaps an incense stick.
Okay. You light a stick of incense and you kneel beside them and you say a few elvish words in their honor. You do get quite a few strange looks from the group of civilians. They're still obviously very grateful, but Elvish gods are rarely worshipped in Citadel. Are really openly worshipped inside of Citadel. Pardon?
Let alone by a Dragonborn.
Let alone by a Dragonborn. So you do get a few questioning looks, but no one obviously comes over. Although one person, the man approaches you again, Husker, the guy that left a second ago, you know, like held on the shoulder, and he comes back and goes, are you guys all together, like, a group?
In a transient sense, I suppose.
Yes.
Alright, I just went around and, he pulls, like, a small bag of, coin, it looks like, and hands it over. It's just a little, thank you from the people that you saved today. If you could make sure that everyone in your little group gets a bit, that'd be appreciated.
Sure. In a rare act, I kind of brush that aside and I say, who is there family here of those who have passed on?
Not that anyone has come forward yet. The guard will transport them to the temple district that houses the cemetery. And it will be found from there. Everyone is registered, so it shouldn't be too hard to find them.
Very well. You should still get out of here. We don't know if this could happen again. This could still be dangerous. Take your people and get yourself help.
Thank you. And he like does one nod and again just like sort of firmly grabs your shoulder and shakes it one last time and then starts heading back to the group of civilians who also have already started disobeying already, but the few that are left behind, he sort of like suggests that they go and like pushes them on, and then leaves himself. Mm. At which point, about a few moments later, the guards arrive. Funny enough, the first guard that arrives is the guard that talked to you first last time. It seems like maybe he is he's like the guy you go to when demons attack, sort of arrives. Of course, it's all you once more. Thank you again. I will eventually stop having to say that, I'm sure, but well met. Is it all dealt with her now?
Well, thanks to you.
It is.
Yes, it is complicated. Yes, it is, because we do not police this area, if you cannot tell. It isn't our responsibility to... As much as I wish it was, it isn't our responsibility to protect these people. And I came as soon as I could. And I am greatly ashamed that, as he looks around, that resulted in... deaths, but I cannot do anything about it, unfortunately.
Who can? Who's your supervisor?
I need to speak to your manager immediately.
It is just the way the city is positioned. We have been told to stay out of these districts by royal authority, and therefore, as we only enter in emergencies, really. There is a few bastions staggered around, but they're... And he sort of, like, walks in a bit closer as he, like, he quickly turns to his men and goes, like, just collect the bodies, take them to the entrance, and just keep peace for a little while. And then he walks a bit closer to Husker and goes, the bastions that are placed within the city are nothing more than trained farmhands that are easily manipulable. So, unfortunately, I'm trying my best. But I thank you for keeping me honest. Well done again. I don't have a reward for you currently, but I'm sure I can arrange something if you would like. Is everyone alright? Apart from the obvious.
We'll be fine. What are the chances some of the townsfolk here can get some weaponry from the guard and perhaps a small amount of training so that they can protect themselves in the future if we're not available to help them, and most certainly you won't be here to help them, but perhaps you can...
It may be something I could requisition. I hope you understand this hasn't happened before. There has been frequent right. attacks to the walls within the recent past, but never within it. I was talking to a mage and there was something about the specific location that they arrive isn't very easy to pinpoint unless they have an anchor. So perhaps they have infiltrators now. That's great. And it's all like, oh.
What would an anchor be like? What would it, do you know, is it something, is it someone?
I'm not a mage. I am not sure. He just used the word anchor. All I can imagine it as is an actual anchor, but I don't know what one would be so far away from the ocean. Perhaps you could talk to him, or if you have a mage among you, they might be able to give insight on this.
Yes, Briar, do you have any insight into that?
I'm at the fountain, I'm not in this conversation.
You can't hear it, it's not a large square, but yeah, you're not actively participating.
I'm gonna start yelling it. You have any insight? Scholar.
You hear that. Right, it's kind of hard to believe that you can't hear that.
Don't respond to me.
Okay, cool.
I think we just need a bit more time, but should we have any further questions or concerns, I'm sure it's no problem for us to seek you out.
You know what, I have a question. Do you do this often? The whole killing creatures thing?
Yes, of recent we have. We haven't really sought it out, per se, but it's been... these situations have presented themselves to us quite frequently. And we deal with it as they come up. Why do you ask?
Did I give you my name already?
We probably forgot it.
Yes.
What, are we supposed to come calling for you and you'll show up 20 minutes later?
It was probably a fake one anyway. I've been told to. My name is Alric. And he like puts out his hand to Gregor,
like
specifically. Alric.
With an A on
yeah.
you.
A.
Okay.
Oh. Alric.
And puts his hand towards Gregor.
Gregor.
Do you take his
I
hand?
I shake Alric's hand.
He goes, I have been put in charge of a team to try to identify and deal with the demon plight we are currently having, but I'm not having a good time of it, if you can't tell. I am being dragged all across the city, at the moment where there was an attack here, there was also three attacks along the walls, which is why I was a little late to arrive. It seems that they are coordinated at least, but that is besides the point for now. I wanted to see if I could hire you.
Seems like you should. We're doing your job anyway.
Indeed. Mm. This way I might be able to offer you more help, sir. I hope you do understand I'm not the enemy here. I'm trying my best.
I understand that. What would be the terms of this employment?
You understand, I will try to give as much information as I can, but until you accept the job, because of the nature of it being an invasion on the city, I can't share too much of the information that we have. Correct?
I suppose you're right.
We are planning to mount a counteroffensive at some point, and we need to make preparations, including certain things that need collecting and certain creatures that need slaying.
See that thing?
Would you give us a moment?
Scare me.
Sure, I'll be over there. And he sort of like walks over to these scorch marks which are now on the ground from when the portals opened, and he like kneels down and starts like touching it, and seems to cast like a spell very quickly.
Okay. I want to go over to Briar. I kind of inform her of the whole conversation. Hopefully all of us are kind of around for that. So should we take up this job? Is this mutually beneficial to what we're already doing?
I don't know about all of you three, but my plans were really just to keep people safe. And if this helps me do it, then I'd be happy to.
Right. Maybe that, did we just tell him that?
Are we committing to staying in the Citadel if we do that?
I don't know. I will ask. I would like to move freely as we would want to. If it is just helping people, then I don't see a problem with it. Kind of feel like we all should be agreed upon it.
Probably be beneficial if I am the anchor, then
we are definitely the anchor. That's
at least he knows where we are. Right?
Right.
Can we have that conversation eventually?
What is that conversation, Husker? We already talked about the fact it's on me and we can't do anything about it.
I've been trying amputating your fingers.
Do it. And I give him a hand.
Oh. Nope, we're not cutting any limbs off now.
I've got a wrist in my hand.
Nope. You notice that after this recent brush with the demons, it spread maybe past your wrist at this point.
I'm careful not to touch it. I don't want to touch it. But I'm grabbing like right below it.
Okay.
Give me your axe, Gregor.
Nope, I will not.
Give it to me, Greg.
No.
Gregor.
I will not give you my axe, feathered one.
We can be finished with this in an instant.
I walk over to Ark. Ark, all we want to do is help people. So if this does it, sure, we will help you with this problem. Though I do want to ask, are we confined to staying in Citadel, or can we freely leave as we need?
I will. Gregor, you said your name was right, yes? Correct?
Yes, it is.
I will offer you a job. I will tell you the payment you will get for it. Whether or not you take it or stay or do it is really up to you. But I'm hoping you will. You've proved useful, and the more work you do for me, the more I can most likely requisition for you to have as a reward. So really, it is up to you.
Alright, we will, if we can, we will help, so...
Don't be mistaken, though, Gregor. We're talking about demons teleporting to us. If it isn't a problem for just us, it soon won't be, if you understand me.
Oh, yes, I do. This is something none of us have seen before, I think. So... We do recognize that it is beneficial for everyone for this problem to not happen, so long as the people way up there, I point to like the top, aren't the only ones protected.
Then I'm sure you'll do a very good job. If your intentions are to protect the people and not protect the people up there, then this is up to you, yes?
Yes. Alright, then I think we are agreed.
Alright, let me manage the site for a small while, and then I will come and talk to you and your companions about the job ahead.
Alright. I go back and relay all that information to the folks.
So we'll wait for a bit.
I guess we can look around in this battlefield to see if they left anything.
You do remember the demon bodies particularly haven't been touched yet at all, because it's your guys' responsibility to deal with that first.
Okay, I want to go look at the closest demon body.
We'll say roll me perception. Anyone that wants to look at the bodies, roll me perception, and we'll go over what you guys find.
I want to pull Thal aside as Gregor starts to do that.
I'll help Gregor then.
20, not that.
I assume you let go of my hand to go talk to them.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Husker, we'll do Husker and Thal first.
Yeah, I'm. Are you going along with that? Like, I'm dragging you by the wrist. We need to talk.
Can I help you?
We need to talk.
About what?
You seem unsettled by the sight of those bodies. Do you deal with death often? Civilian death. Regrettable death.
See, I lived and worked in a church for about 5 years, and part of that daily routine was tending to the church, praying, helping people. Sometimes they were dead. Sometimes I had to assist in funerals.
Did you get used to that?
Kind of.
Good, because you're going to need to be. That girl, your sister, is not an anchor. She's an albatross around all of our necks. Have you seen that clearly yet? She's a weight, stone, dragging all of us down, and I won't be here when the other shoe drops. I'll be gone.
Earth, then leave. I don't want you talking about my sister that way. I don't want you near us if you're just going to think of her as a weight.
What else is there to think?
Think of her way to help. Think of her way to get rid of it.
I thought of one. You didn't seem to like it.
In a moment. Look. If... I don't know how strong healing magic really gets, okay? But if we find a way to, I don't know, regenerate limbs somehow, then I go along with it. and only if she is okay with it.
Until then, you're willing to let innocence die. That is the price you are proposing. The price to pay.
What makes you think I'm gonna slack on it?
We already lost too. That is your burden now. Those deaths are your burden. The deaths that will follow are your burden.
Fine, sure, ignore the part that you played a part in too. You were there as well.
You don't get it. You want to keep protecting her, that's fine. But no, what comes next is on you. I leave him.
And I'll go help with the bodies.
Okay. We'll see first. What did you roll, Gregor?
I rolled a 20, not now.
Okay.
22.
Okay, as you're looking around, you do find a few things. So, we'll say that Gregor goes over to one of the bearded devil's body. Gregor, you find the glaive that it has seems to have lost some sort of like the shadowy property it has, but still seems to be there.
Okay. I kind of use my battle axe so it's scooted away from the body, and then I pick it up.
Okay. Upon picking it up, it's a glaive. It feels weighty.
Hmm.
That's all you do find, though, as you're looking over it.
Okay.
Faldron, roll me investigation. What were you going to say, Gregor?
I will look at it curiously and then put it somewhere on my back, maybe, to think about using in the future.
No problem. You rolled a 22?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let me find this. Where is it? Yeah?
Sorry.
Grinning at.
I just wanted to say something, but I'll wait till after we're done.
Go on.
No, until we're done this stream.
Oh, okay.
Oh boy.
Oh no. You find a small, about 5 inch across, about an inch thick coin made out of a dark iron.
Cool. Big quarter.
It weighs about a third of a pound when you pick it up. And you read Inferno, right?
I do.
It's inscribed with infernal writing.
What does it say?
It's an infernal Chuck E. Cheese token.
I owe you.
No. It says, roll me D100.
Lord, 47. We have
47 days. I need to check something very quickly. What did you roll, Thal?
Oh, I didn't roll. I was gonna go over to Briar instead.
Okay, you don't want to look instead? Okay. You head on over to Briar. While she's looking at the conjurer, to say something. Go ahead, just do. You guys do you whilst I check.
Are you actually fine with your hand being cut off?
In some aspects, yes. I mean, it would definitely make my livelihood harder, being a spellcaster, but if it meant that I was no longer anchoring demons to this world, I feel like that's a fair price to pay. I can find other things to do.
No, look, here's what I'm thinking. I despise the idea, but... What if we go to the owner people? They had a healer among them. Let's see if we can trust them, see how good they are. See if they can help you get it back, if it does get cut off. Sure, I'm thinking about the greater good here, but I also don't want you to lose your livelihood. The things you love to do, all that.
I think that's a great idea. I want to talk to them anyway. I want to know... My curiosity is getting the better of me, and I want to know what happened with the king, and I'm sure it was boring paperwork. But I can't help but wonder. He had an arm blade.
I'll admit I'm a bit curious too.
And I want to know if the note means that he's gone, like he's out of the group, or if he's out and he is safe.
Oh, well, I imagine it's the latter.
I hope it's
out,
the latter.
Safe with him.
They just said he's out, meet us here. It could mean either.
Also, they just said Castle's Rest.
Well, yes, they're getting special treatment by the royal family, I assume.
Do we just go in and ask for them?
The queen knows us? I don't see why we couldn't go into Castle's Rest. Maybe not into the castle. But if we have a letter from the queen, I'm sure they would let us into the upper housing.
We can try it. I just feel like if they're good enough at healing, this would be a faster way of getting it out than going back to the way we were in prison or searching blindly.
Are you sure, though? I know that you're not particularly fond of more aggressive religions.
It's for your sake. Don't worry about it. Besides, they might be fun people.
They seem
who knows?
Friendly, except maybe the dwarf. Right, Brigham made
a
friend.
Oh yeah, we're steering clear of the dwarf.
Avoid the dwarf at all costs.
It's fine.
I'd imagine Gregor wants to talk to... What's his name, Al?
Yes, probably. Right. I mean, I don't know what more they would have to say to each other, but maybe about... I don't know, just sort of like do the dead symbol, you know. All that.
Maybe. We'll see.
We'll
at least for me, this is a primary focus, trying to find a solution for you.
You haven't picked up the coin yet. By the way.
I haven't picked it
up. No, it's like on the, it's still where it was.
Okay, I go like...
Wait, don't pick that up.
don't
pick that up.
Okay.
Do it.
Two things. First of all, what's your constitution? Modifier?
Two.
Two?
Yes.
Okay, that's fine.
Two.
As you pick up the coin, you are overcome with fear, but less fear, more anxiety. For a moment, and then it sort of recedes. On the coin is written Alevor Devine.
Alevor Devine. A-L-E-V-O-R?
A-L-A-V-O-R.
Devine. D-A-V-I-N-E?
Yes.
It's an anxiety quarter.
And is that all it says?
Yes.
Do I still feel panicky?
How would anyone want
you
that?
You feel a bit unsettled.
If I put it back down, do I still feel uncomfortable?
No, but you... yes, but... No, you don't feel uncomfortable anymore. But you know as soon as you touch it, you know exactly what it is.
Oh.
This is a soul coin. It is... You don't know a lot about it, but you do feel as if there is something you can do with it.
Heard about souls before.
It needs to be identified to get the full thing. You know, just automatically you know it's called a soul coin. Does anybody else look around for anything before we end the session?
Oh, don't get me angry.
I'm gonna stick with Briar.
Gregor, do you wanna keep looking? You were 22, right? Maybe.
I rolled 20.
Okay, yeah, you find one more thing as well, another body, unless you stop looking when you find the coin.
I'll keep looking, but I'm sort of like talking to Thal as it's happening. Just
that's
sort of
fine.
Being like, I think it might have a person's soul in it.
Excuse me?
I think, I'm not sure, I mean, it's a soul, I know it's a soul coin. I need to look over it properly to be able to tell you anything more than that, but it makes me nervous. Yep.
You learned a lot, Thermbora.
I did, yeah. Do you want to hold it? Probably not, but...
Why not? It doesn't matter that I came from a demon.
Does it make you nervous?
I guess.
What's your constitution modifier, Dave?
Let me check. It is 2.
You're fine.
Ooh.
I don't feel anything.
I think it has a name on it. Either that or it's some sort of magic word. Like a opening phrase. I don't want to say it in case it is a magic word.
Smart. Don't want to summon anything.
Open sesame.
But I will, when we have a moment to sit down, I'll cast Identify and I'll have a look over it. And...
Sure.
If it's bad, we'll get rid of it. Somehow.
Good idea.
And then I rummage around the other body.
Okay, one second, I need to make sure.
You look so confused.
I am very.
What does this guy have? Oh my god.
Who the fuck is Alvar Devine?
Also, I found
It's in the coin.
I also found a gem the last time we looked over some bodies that definitely is linked to the, like, hell. Or whatever you call it in your religion.
Oh, fascinating.
It's not connected anymore, but it's from there.
Did you keep
a fair
it?
Penny,
yes. Okay, you find a book.
Ooh.
Book?
It's got tattered pages and ripped leather. It looks like it's been sewn together from many different creatures. And it's a book. It requires attunement, so it's going to require you to identify it to find out what it is. But
if I open and flick through it, is there like any...
There's a lot of arcane writing in it.
I don't know if this is human flesh or like I don't know what it is. Leather? Maybe it's just leather.
Human leather?
Human flesh is just leather if it's woman? Not a person anymore.
I touch it.
It feels rough.
Touch it.
Feels rough.
Yeah.
This is how we got into this mess in the first place.
Just touch everything.
Y'all ADD little shits having to touch everything.
I could look over this as well.
Do you have identification prepped just so we can get through it before the end of the session?
I've got it prepped. I have a ritual cast if I want to, but I only have one slot. Oh no, I have second level slots. I guess I could use them up.
What's the deal? I'm just asking.
But if it's ritual cast, you don't use slots anyway,
nope.
Right? If we want to spend 20 minutes for me to look them over, as an endgame.
It would be...
Or 22.
30 minutes. Mm. Because it's 3 items.
Oh, what's the third one?
The spear.
Oh.
The glaive, if you want to look at it. Like I'm not saying it isn't... None of these things particularly give off a magical aura, apart from the soul coin. But you can check.
I wouldn't really I don't think I'd care too much about the glaive unless someone asked me to look over it.
Is Gregor gonna ask?
Gregor?
Oh, we can't hear Gregor.
Oh no.
Uh oh. Mute yourself.
Gregor lost his voice.
Oh wait, here we go. No, I will not ask for it to be identified at the moment. I just like spinning it around for now.
I think
even
with my high intelligence, I just assume that it is what it was doing before. Like, I don't really...
Well, when you identify the soul coin, you know a few things about it. You know that a evil creature can carry as many soul coins as they want. A non-evil creature can only carry an amount of soul coins equal to their heartiness, which in this case is their constitution modifier. But you don't know what happens if that is broken.
Okay.
You do know that the soul coin, a soul has 3 charges, and a charge can be expended from it to use one of the following. You can either drain life, which would give you 1d10 temporary hit points.
Okay.
Or you can query it, which means you can telepathically ask the soul a question and receive a brief telepathic response, which you understand. It only knows what it knew in life, but it must answer truthfully. And to the best of its ability, so no avoidance either.
Mm.
There is a way to free it, but you are not aware of that yet.
Okay.
You also would know that this is hellish currency. It's basically something that you could trade with another demon for either another coin or for services or for...
Do I need to be...
Devil, not
right.
Devil, sorry.
It is a Chuck E. Cheese token.
Do I need to be attuned to it to do that? Or could I just do it?
It is not attuned.
Okay, then I pass that information on and sort of put the coin to the side for everyone around me.
Just like put it on the table.
Yeah, like if you guys...
You put it on the side of the fountain.
Yeah.
Throw it into the fountain.
If you want. And I just sort of put it down and then go back to the book.
Yeah.
The book?
I go to the book, yeah.
Okay, and 10 minutes and 6 seconds later, you find the Plane Caller's Codex. It is a wondrous item that requires attunement by a wizard.
Oh, bitch.
Wizard.
The book is bound in fiend hide.
That's fine.
And the cover is embossed with the diagram of the great wheel of the multiverse.
Great.
When found, the book contains the following spells, which they can be used. So this can be used as a spellcaster focus, but you can't cast spells that you aren't of the level to cast.
Yeah.
Basically, when you get to the right level, you get these spells for free if you use this book. But do bear in mind that the spells inside this book and the spells inside your book are different books.
Yeah, two different.
So you can't use these spells if you're wielding your other book.
Yeah.
In this book is Banishment, Find Familiar, Gate, Magic Circle, Planar Binding, and Summon Elemental.
Planar Binding?
And it functions as a spell book. When holding the book, you can use it as a spellcaster focus for your wizard spells. Oh, for your wizard spells, never mind. You can do.
Oh,
so.
Cool.
It's a good book.
The book has 3 charges, and it regains 1d3 expended charges daily at dawn. When you use all the charges, there's a 60% chance of burning away, just so you're aware.
6%?
60. Let me check. I'll check that in a second. It's the same as all the other rest of ones when you use up all the charges. It doesn't say on here, though.
6 is weird.
No, I think 60 is a pretty
60.
High percentage.
Oh,
yeah.
That's worse.
If you spend 1 minute studying the book, you can expend 1 charge to replace one of your prepared spells with a different spell in the book, but the spell has to be of the conjuration school.
Okay.
And when you cast a conjuration spell that summons or creates one creature, you can expend 1 charge to grant that creature advantage on attack rolls for a whole minute.
Hmm. Okay. I'll explain all of that as I'm learning it as well.
Seems like a very cool, fleshy book, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
This is my flesh book.
I suppose I could keep it to the side.
Side of. What? Oh, cool.
I'm gonna just snip the part that you can use of Soul Coin because I need to make a new one where it's like the stuff that you don't know is covered at some point, but.
Okay.
Do bear in mind the Soul Coin though doesn't regain any charges. Once its 3 charges are used, it becomes non magical. And that, my friends, is where we will end the session for today.
Right.
I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you in 2 weeks.
Uh-huh.
It was fun.
For the next session.
Why 2 weeks?
It's just how it works. Weeks, that's how the cookie crumbles. Mm. Oh no, Gregor is now muted again, but he is hiding behind his mace.
Wait, am I muted? No.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, I guess I didn't mute myself. Yes, that is how the cookie crumbles. I apologize.
It's okay.
Seven.
It's okay.
And we'll see you later. Salutes for the captain. and goodbye.